better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
A questionable decision and new video causing grief for House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. The video shows her inside a hair salon this week in San Francisco. That is apparently against the rules. No indoor visits allowed. She's also seen not wearing a mask.
Maybe she was listening to the president who said masks are weakness. Who's always encouraging people to take off masks.
You need help. You need professional help.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
I take responsibility for trusting the word of a neighborhood salon that I've been to over the years many times.
We have found a witch. May we burn her?
Who do you know she is a witch?
She looks like one.
As it turns out, it was a setup.
I'm just a patsy.
So I take responsibility for falling for a setup. And that's all I'm going to say on that.
And that's all I had to say about that.
Instead of claiming a setup, it would have been just as easy for the speaker to say, you know what, I messed up.
It's kind of strange coming from you.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
President Trump has actively been trying to kill New York City ever since he's been elected. He can't come back to New York. He can't. He's going to walk down the street in New York. Forget bodyguards. He better have an army if he thinks he's going to walk down the street in New York.
You know something, Princess? You are ugly when you're angry.
Unchained and unstoppable.
Mail-in voting is fraught with the risk of fraud and coercion.
But since then,
and until this haven't proved it. Let me talk.
Yeah, please.
The only time the narrative changed is after this administration came in. And people trying to change the rules to this methodology is reckless and dangerous. And the people are playing with fire.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
I want to warn everybody of a scam that's going on in the United States. Be forewarned about this. If your hair's getting a little shaggy, you know, you're a woman and you need something, you know, you need a little highlights done, do not allow yourself to be set up. I mean, even the master political strategist of our generation, our era, Nancy Pelosi, was set up in San Francisco. She was framed. She was railroaded. It was kind of like a Russian collusion hoax of beauty shops. And she was trapped. Now they're going to get that. That beauty shop operator in San Francisco, the city by the bay, she's going to go down like Kevin Kleinsmith, the crooked FBI lawyer who tried to frame Carter Page.
Well, she claims there was cosmetic collusion.
Yes. It's just so good. I can't believe it. And we were laughing yesterday and Grace and I about how they always try to make her out to be the master political strategist, right? And they she's the most brilliant tactician in Capitol Hill since Sam Rayburn, the speaker, or Lyndon Johnson. And sure enough, today, Chris Saliza, the sleazy columnist, formerly of the Washington Post, and now for CNN, he writes a column about what a disaster this is for the Democrats that this has happened, because everybody understands it. But the first line in the column is, Nancy Pelosi is a master political strategist. I mean, they're so predictable. They don't even try to come in with a change up every once in a while, you know? 844-500-4242. 508 says, please, Mr. President, go to New York City. Somebody tweeted out today, somebody who's in with the cops in New York City, may even be a New York City cop. He said, you know, Cuomo said, well, he would need an army if he came to New York City to protect him. And this guy said half the people on the NYPD would volunteer. They wouldn't even get paid. They would volunteer to protect him. And the other thing is, it's not the president that needs an army to protect him if he came back to New York City. It's the people who live in New York City who haven't been able to get out.
all of these Fox anchors like Melissa Francis and Ainsley Earhart, they all have young kids and they have to live in the city because, or at least close to the city because right. that's where they work. And Melissa Francis tweeted out, I feel like everyone needs an army. I was walking my daughter to preschool and look what was in front of me. And she tweeted out a photo of a man with no pants on walking 2 feet in front of her. So it's like bragging about how your city is in shambles is not a good look, Andrew. And you know what, Howie, I was thinking about? You are so happy that the Kennedy political dynasty has ended.
Yes.
I think the Cuomo political dynasty needs to end soon.
Well, the Kennedy dynasty and the Cuomo dynasty are intertwined, you know, right? I mean, Kerry used to be married to him until she took up with the polo player.
Right, they do have that connection.
Right, and one of the Cuomo daughters, they did have to call an ambulance because she passed out a couple of years ago. And just I don't know what happened. Maybe she got the vapors. But it's, you know, it's they run together. 844-500-4242. 774, Captain, I volunteered to be part of Trump's New York Army because I'm a lawman. I can even carry weapons from Massachusetts to New York. And 413 says, how can Cuomo walk New York City after killing tens of thousands of New Yorkers? Right. Exactly. And we don't even know how many he killed because they're not even keeping numbers as well as Massachusetts is. And they've scrambled the numbers again today, by the way. I looked at the, we posted the numbers, but there's been another updated data. It's just so bad. 844-500-4242. Let's see here. Let's play Biden. Biden is backpedaling. He's in Kenosha right now. I don't know if he's going to meet with Jacob Blake Sr. This is the father of the guy who was shot. It turns out that this guy has on his social media, he has a history of posting not just the anti-Semitic stuff like Joy Reid. This is rabidly anti-Semitic, or it just Joy Reid is anti-Islamophobic and homophobic. This guy is anti-Semitic. Just really awful stuff that I can't even read a lot of it. You know, this is like a lot of this, increasingly the stuff that's ending up on social media that's getting people into trouble. I can't even read it on the air. It's so nasty. I mean, they're not self-editing at all. All right. 844-500-4242. So anyway, I just want to give you an example of Biden backpedaling here. Okay. This is Biden on the on masks, mandating masks. Cut three.
What would you do differently regarding the pandemic and getting these surging cases now under control?
I would go back to making sure that everybody had masks, that you had PPE lined up. We have been making sure we stockpile all the things that we need that we don't have now. The one thing we do know, these masks make a gigantic difference. I would insist that everybody on public be wearing that mask.
I would insist. I would insist that everybody in public, be wearing that mask, okay? He would insist. Go ahead.
Sure that they walked into a business that had masks.
Couldn't you use your federal leverage to mandate that, though?
Yes.
And you would you?
Yes, I would, from an executive standpoint. Yes, I would.
So
that was then. This is now.
But so you don't see, you had suggested there would be some kind of a federal mandate about masks. So now you're saying
what I suggested was I would ask every person in authority. There's a question whether or not a president under the Constitution could mandate everyone wear a mask. And remember, all during the primary, I'd have a lot of people telling me I would by executive order do. I'm a constitutionalist. You can't do things the Constitution doesn't allow you the power to do. What I would be doing is putting as much pressure as I could on every governor, every senator, mayor, every county executive, every local official, and everyone in business, putting pressure on them to say, what you're doing is irresponsible. Make sure you wear a mask and maintain social distancing.
You're going to put pressure on that's enough. So he's a constitutionalist now. So he was he was against the Constitution before he was for the Constitution. Just like he was for, he was against fracking before he was for fracking. And he was for confiscating firearms before he was against confiscating firearms. And oh, by the way, he's going to use as his firearm czar, Beto O'Rourke, who is directly on record as saying that he would confiscate all AR-15s. And how many tens of millions of AR-15s are there out there? 844-500-4242, 844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. We have got a voter fraud story that's going to amuse and appall you at the same time. And then I'm going to pass it on to Donald Trump Jr. at 4:30 directly. And he'll pass it on to Dad. I have no doubt. If Dad doesn't know about it already as he sets down in Pennsylvania. Many are feeling nervous about the stock market as the election gets closer. I know I am. I just stopped putting money in my 401k into the stock market. I'm just putting it into money markets and bonds right now. It's important now more than ever to look at where your money is and not put your head in the sand. Bill O'Reilly is here to help. He's hosting the Great American Wealth Project alongside best-selling financial author Alexander Green. Their goal, to show Americans what it takes to create a dream retirement. Go to HowieCarrShow.com and click on the Bill O'Reilly banner. You should feel secure about your portfolio, about your future. Watch Bill O'Reilly and Alexander Green as they discuss how you can achieve the American dream starting today. Just go to HowieCarrShow.com and click on the Bill O'Reilly banner. Start feeling secure about your life savings and investments today by watching O'Reilly's Great American Wealth Project. HowieCarrShow.com and click on the Bill O'Reilly banner. I'm Howie Carr.
You're tuned into the Howie Carr Radio Network.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show was brought to you in part by Ken's Place in Scarborough, Maine. Stop by today and have one of my favorite world-famous batter-dipped fried clams. They are the best in the world. That's Ken's Place on Route 9 in Scarborough, Maine.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
How did you come up with the name VB?
My first producer and I both had steady girlfriends, or we were married or whatever. And VB was always saying that we were whipped, if you know what I mean. Finally, I said, you don't even have a girlfriend. I've never seen you with a female. As a matter of fact, I don't think you have ever had sex. You are just a virgin boy.
What is your biggest fear?
That Donald Trump will not be reelected in 2020 and that some horrible Democrat will come in and finish off the destruction of this once great country.
Out of all of your daughters, who is the least like you and why?
Probably Charlotte, even though we went to the same high school, Deerfield Academy. She has a different sense of her responsibilities than I do. Let me put it that way. She has a different regard for money. She's not a cheap bastard, in other words. With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show, and for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a 2-year contract. You just order online. Set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more. All for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a state job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
the investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it. I'd probably be dead if I were still working for them.
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring three things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer, and I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books, too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places.
This is Alex from East Bridgewater, Mass.
This is Ann in Saco, Maine.
This is John Zuko from Hanson, Mass. And this is The Howie Carr Show.
844-500-4242. Biden is in Kenosha, Wisconsin right now. He's talking to some community members, quote unquote, and he's wearing a mask. I mean, we've got the sound turned down here in the studio, but he looks like a damn fool. I think I'm being charitable.
Did he need the mask to look like one?
It accentuates his damn foolishness. Today's poll question is brought to you by Genesis 950, sending warm thoughts to all the cars after Mr. Gooner's passing. Before you replace your carpets due to pet stains, try Genesis 950. It breaks down the bonds of stains and odors from the carpet and padding. Order direct at genesis950.com. Put in code word Howie and get free shipping and a free spray bottle with a 1 gallon purchase of Genesis 950. That's a $10 savings. And I mentioned earlier today that, you know, if you get a phone call, you know, like they say phishing or something like that, they ask you, they want your social security number, your password, all this stuff. The new thing is barbershops, hair salons calling you up and offering you a blow, dry, a trim, you know, whatever, you know, a standard wash. And don't respond. Don't respond. Look what happened to Nancy Pelosi.
Down here next to me in this lonely crowd,
I have been inundated.
There's a man who swears he's not to blame.
I think that they that this salon owes me an apology.
All day long I hear him cry so loud.
Do you have any questions about the fact that people are dying?
Calling out that he's been framed.
As it turns out, it was a setup.
It was a setup. Taylor, what's the poll question and what are the responses?
Was Nancy Pelosi set up?
No.
93% say no.
7% say she was set up. Wow. 844-500-4242. What a clown. Even Don Lemon didn't give her much of an out. Cut 12.
This is this far into the pandemic. The House Speaker should know what is safe and what isn't. We should all know.
She does know.
It's our responsibility.
She does
Instead
know.
Of claiming a setup, it would have been just as easy for the Speaker to say, you know what? I messed up. I should have worn a mask indoors.
How about this? You know what? This is all BS. We tried to keep it going. We tried to keep this scam going all the way through to the election, but it's over, okay? I screwed up. I should have worn a mask.
Didn't she fault President Trump for not wearing a mask because he's in a high-risk category because he's obese?
Right.
Isn't she in a high-risk category because she's ancient?
She's 80 years old. She's older than Joe Biden? Yes, she's definitely in a high-risk phase. Not to mention she's in San Francisco. It can't be very healthy to be stepping out onto the street in San Francisco. Plus everything has been cratered in San Francisco. There was a report came out today. Restaurant business in San Francisco is down 84%. So that means for every $6 restaurants were selling in San Francisco last year, they're selling $1 today. Yes.
How dare you both say she's high risk? The only thing she's high risk of is getting set up. She is a high risk of being set up. by salon owners.
You know, I've known a lot of Pauls that had big you-know-whats, and they would say absolutely anything under any circumstances, but I can't remember ever hearing a Boston Paul say, I was set up, when they've got him on videotape. Even Diane Wilkerson, stuffing the $100 bills into her bra. She never said she was set up. She may have said it was racist, but I don't think she ever used this, said it was set, she was set up. What's amazing. 844-500-4242. How about the Attorney General Barr with Wolf Blitzer? This is just he was really good with the Wolf Man here, talking about the amazing fraud, and we're gonna hear about the fraud in just a moment or two. But let's play Cup 4.
This is a, you know, sort of cheap talk to get around the fundamental problem, which is the bipartisan commission chaired by Jimmy Carter and James Baker said back in 2009 that mail-in voting is fraught with the risk of fraud and coercion.
But since then, and, there have and been until a lot this administration,
no, well, sorry,
they haven't proved it.
Let me talk.
Yeah, please.
And since that time, there have been in the newspapers, in networks, academic studies saying it is open to fraud and coercion. The only time the narrative changed is after this administration came in. But elections that have been held with mail have found substantial fraud and coercion.
Yeah, exactly. What about Paterson, New Jersey, just to cite one example? What about this example we're just about to cite? Cut 5.
But there are individual cases, but as far as widespread fraud, we haven't seen that since...
We haven't had the kind of widespread use of mail-in ballots that's being proposed. We've had absentee ballots from people who request them from a specific address. Now what we're talking about is mailing them to everyone on the voter list when everyone knows those voter lists are inaccurate. People who should get them don't get them, which is what has been one of the major complaints in states that have tried this in municipal elections. And people who get them are not the right people. They're people who have replaced the previous occupant, and they can make them out. And sometimes multiple ballots come to the same address with a whole several generations of occupants. Do you think that's a way to run a vote?
Wolf would also make the argument that, you know, not that many people have been killed recently in atomic bomb explosions. Why are we so concerned about nuclear warfare? Nothing has really happened in 75 years, right? What's the problem? Okay, Wolf, we'll be right back with James O'Keefe from Project Veritas. You're going to enjoy this. I'm Howie Carr.
Hey, Howie. It was amazing how many listeners wanted the Fresh Rest bedding sheets during the Cheap Aster deal.
We sold out in 10 minutes, but I feel bad for all the listeners that didn't get a set.
I have some good news. Fresh Rest bedding is selling all sheets at 40% off now through September while supplies last.
Oh, that's great. How do they get them?
Go to FreshRestBedding.com. For all orders over $50, you can also get free shipping. Fresh Rest bedding controls dust mites and pet dander. Fresh Rest bedding.
Alexander Hamilton said, "Those who stand for nothing will fall for anything." This is Toby from Cape Gunworks. When our founding fathers drafted the Second Amendment, there was no question of its meaning. Today, if you have questions, come to Cape Gunworks for some advice, training, or to send a few rounds downrange. We have a fully stocked pro shop with a huge selection of guns, crossbows, archery, classes, rentals, a 15-lane range, and a friendly staff. Come on down to Cape Gunworks, Airport Road, Hyannis, or CapeGunworks.com.
He's New England's talk radio king. He's Howie Carr.
The only French term I like is sans culotte, without trousers. I used to describe Ted Kennedy as sans culotte. Because after the O'Barr incident, when he was wandering around down on the beach with his 20th scotch tumbler of the day in his hand, stumbling around with an off. He was just there, as Michelle Cassone, Patches Date, said. He was just there. Without trousers, or as we say in Paris, sans culotte.
We've seen nothing that we can work, that I can work with President Bush on, and I'm disappointed because I thought
that there might be some interest because of what he said in the campaign.
President Bush, this is your brain. This is your brain on Botox, okay? That's the lesson of that one. You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day, once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them, now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's why I'm saying I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have three houses, besides the ones you already have, anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue. Maybe a place in southern Maine. I don't need a third place.
Didn't you already have a house in Maine?
I did. It was on an island. It was not a good fit for the mailroom manager.
I've heard the house was haunted. Is that true?
Yes. And my wife didn't really care that much for my relatives. And now, another minute of Madam Speaker, Nancy Pelosi.
But, again, don't...
You have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
That's like five people. They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame. Except we don't say sesame, we say open Biden. But no, I because the we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican, 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
We just played some cuts from Attorney General William Barr about the potential for voter fraud in the upcoming election with the unhinged Democrat Party. And the president has been talking about it a lot, and he thinks specifically New Hampshire. He talks about it all the time. Every time I seem to talk to him, he's talking about New Hampshire, what happened to him. He lost by 3,000 votes. Kelly Ayotte lost the Republican Senate seat up there to Hassan by fewer than 1,000 votes. And there'll be less of it this year because there probably won't be any college students in the area. But the fraud continues in New Hampshire, and I think the president is going to find out about this next case that we're going to discuss here. Joining us now is James O'Keefe from Project Veritas. James, thanks for being with us here again. You're doing a great job. You've been involved with these problems in New Hampshire before. I remember in Manchester, New Hampshire, you were just grabbing obits out of the paper, right? And then going down and presenting the name of the dead person in that morning's paper, yeah. And they were giving you a ballot, right?
That is correct. And Howie, thanks for having me on. This is a bombshell story here today. We have identified a man who got in trouble. He voted twice. He evidently created a fake person named Helen Ashley.
Now, what is his name? What is his name? Because people are just driving and they're not paying 100% attention. What's his name?
And his name is Vincent Marcello. And just to be clear, I spoke with the New Hampshire Attorney General yesterday about this issue. I showed them tape of him confessing what he did, and they arrested him. What's interesting is that the Attorney General had this information for 8 months or so and did nothing. So we got this guy to confess, and then he was registered to vote at an address twice. So we built a relationship with him, and he confessed to creating a fake persona named Helen Ashley.
The guy, wait a second. I just want people to understand this. A guy named Vince Marcello became Helen Ashley.
Oh. And he voted as both people. He voted as both people. And what's even more interesting, this is a breaking story, Howie. We're publishing the video imminently. It's not even out yet. I sent you the documents showing the voter affidavit with a wig on. This is hilarious.
We're going to tweet it out immediately. I told Grace to tweet it out as soon as we got on the air. You're not going to believe this. This is going to be retweeted a million times in the next hour.
Unbelievable. So we're on the radio. It's not a television medium, but this is a picture of a man in a wig.
I'm holding it up for our social media right here, but it'll be tweeted out very shortly. And it's not even it's like a joke wig. And he's wearing a fur coat too, right? A female's fur coat, it looks like, right?
Yes, that's correct. He's wearing a female fur coat and a wig. So get this. This is all happening, breaking news. The New Hampshire Attorney General just said they're going to prosecute this guy thanks to Project Veritas. We catch him on tape saying, I got in trouble because I voted twice. The cops came, a long time ago and kind of all swept this under the rug. This is what this guy said.
Right. No, I heard it. Yeah. Yeah.
And then the Democratic Party of New Hampshire, the chairman of which is Ray Buckley, promotes Helen Ashley, which is a fake person, to become an elections inspector. I am not making this up.
You're kidding.
One of the documents I emailed you. I emailed you the document. And if you don't have it,
I'm on Ray Buckley's mailing list. Do you think he's going to email me an explanation of that?
No. I emailed you that document prior to coming on your show.
I'm just saying though. How is he going to explain this? Go ahead.
I'm in New Hampshire tracking these people down with a film crew, I reach out for comment. A week ago, 10 days ago, I'm just trying to put the pieces together. I got this confession. And suddenly, the New Hampshire Attorney General office becomes interested in this. And they announce that I meet with Deputy Attorney General Jane Young yesterday. I walked into the building and just off the street, didn't even call ahead of time. They met with me. I presented the confession and said, but you guys knew about this.
Right.
You guys knew about this. For 8 months, they took and I recorded that conversation. That'll be part two of our expose, Howie. Part one, which is coming out in the next 30 minutes, is this videotape of Vincent Marcello saying that he voted twice.
Right. No, we just saw it. Can we play a little sound from it? Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay, we'll play a little sound. This is this guy, Vincent Marcello, also known as Helen Ashley. Okay,
I got in trouble because I voted twice, and the cops found out because I went to get the voter ID, right? And a state trooper knocked on my door saying, we need to talk to you. What the f*** is this about? I'm ashamed, I'm freaking out. I was almost in tears, And he was like, you felt bad for me. He was cool. He said it's not a big priority, but, or it could be freaking shoved under a bunch of papers and forgot about.
Really?
Who said that?
The cop.
Really? That's fairly damning too, isn't it? That's exactly what Trump and Barr are talking about here.
It is. It is. This is a huge story out of New Hampshire. Apparently what happened was this was given to the Attorney General's office 6-8 months ago. They did nothing. They did nothing. I walk into the Attorney General's office yesterday, having a civilian record this man, not a police officer, civilian, getting this person to admit to this, which is not an easy thing to get someone to admit to, Howie.
Right.
To voting multiple times. I present that to the Attorney General, and voila, you have a prosecution. And this is a guy who created a fake persona named Helen Ashley, apparently even got a voter ID card for Helen Ashley and was promoted as an elections official as a fake person for the Democratic Party of New Hampshire. Unbelievable.
Well, how did he come to the attention of Ray Buckley, the chairman of the New Hampshire Democrat Party?
That is an excellent question. Now, these guys are all flipping over themselves to cover their butts, as you can imagine right now. And the moment I called Ray Buckley, he immediately talked to the Attorney General's office and or immediately issued a letter, a copy of which I currently have, that states that he's being removed from the role. But why he was put as an elections inspector to begin with is a huge question here. Huge question.
Maybe he was promoting himself as a member of the trans community, you know?
That is one of the issues here, which we have not, you know, reported on his sexuality, nor do we care about his sexuality, but there are some questions there.
Well, I mean, what I'm saying is he's registered and voted as a male, and he registered and voted as a female, you know?
That is correct. Yeah, and legally his name is Vincent Marzello. We're unclear. This Helen Ashley is a fraud. It's not a real person.
Where did this picture come from? By the way, where did this picture on the challenged voter affidavit come from? Is your picture taken when your vote is challenged?
This challenged voter affidavit is something you have to do when you don't have a photo identification.
Okay.
And you need to do this, and the Secretary of State needs to follow up, and apparently none of that happened. So this is something that shows the flaws in the voting system. It's almost like the speculation here is that they didn't prosecute this guy because they didn't want to show the flaws in the system, right? Mm-hmm. It's damning.
Right.
So they just sat on it until we got the guy to confess to us. And my question to the Attorney General is, why does your prosecutorial discretion depend upon me coming into your office? That shouldn't influence whether you do something or not. So the other interesting thing here is, Howie, the Attorney General edited out of their press release that I walked into their office and showed them that day. So there's a lot of, this is a crazy story. It's almost like New Hampshire Watergate at this point. And,
yeah.
Breaking news and, you know, videotape is hilarious and troubling and, we've got some.
What I can't figure out too, I looked at the videotape just in the previous break. We're talking to James O'Keefe from Project Veritas. This is a breaking story about a guy who dressed up as a woman and voted twice in New Hampshire, once as a man and once as a woman. He said he voted for the Constitution Party, as a guy, and then he voted for the Democrats as a woman. So, I mean, that's kind of weird, isn't it? I mean, the Constitution Party, that's kind of a fringe, right-leaning party, correct?
Yes, that's correct. So he voted for the Constitution Party as a man. He voted for the Democratic Party as a woman. And he was elected an elections inspector for the Democratic Party, which he got into in July. And just last week, Ray Buckley rescinded that invitation after getting a call from me. So the question is, why did they put this fake person as an elections inspector?
Did you ask Ray Buckley if he knows Helen Ashley?
Ray Buckley hung up the phone on me and then proceeded to take a sequence of action based on the information I gave him.
I shouldn't be laughing, James. I shouldn't be laughing about this. This is terrible.
He should be thanking me. Because, but not for me, he'd have a fake person as an elections inspector in the Democratic Party. He won't even return my call. So he'll write a letter to the Attorney General, of course, but he won't return my call. So, I mean, the Attorney General of New Hampshire should be thanking us.
And you're also giving him a heads up. The primary elections in New Hampshire are Tuesday, right?
Yeah, so, but not for us. This man would be voting as a woman and as a man on Tuesday.
Right.
Another fact that was edited out of the New Hampshire Attorney General's press release. I'm upset at the New Hampshire Attorney General because, but not, they had this file for God knows how long, 8 months.
Mm-hmm.
They had this case. This case, these documents were given to them and they did nothing. And the moment I walked into their office with a confession that I got on the street, they take action, and then edit out that from their press release. There is something fishy going on here in the Attorney General's office here, and it's not good. And I don't know what it says about our elections integrity when this guy can get away with this for as long as he did.
Well, there were thousands.
Story, and there's a lot more coming.
There were thousands of people who voted with out-of-state driver's licenses in New Hampshire. You followed all this, and so then they waited and they gave them a few months. They told the people at the polls told them you have to re-register. You know, you have to get a New Hampshire driver's license. And yet, I think a year later or 6 months later, most of them hadn't gotten the New Hampshire driver's license. So they were basically either students or just transients who were just passing through and decide to vote for the Democrat that day. And yes. And they prosecuted about 10 people, I think, since the last election, right? Not 100, certainly not 100, right?
That's right. One of the things the New Hampshire Attorney General told us is such a busy time, you know, pandemic, so we've been busy. I said, you got a guy voting twice. You know that. You've given the documents. You had the case. What excuse? How many cases like this do you actually have?
Right.
So the question is, why didn't they prosecute this guy for 8 months? Mm-hmm. And that's the story here. The story is the cover-up. I talked to a bunch of people, the city clerk of Lebanon. I talked to the city clerk. He gave me a police officer's name. I talked to him. He said he handed over the file to the AG's office. Nothing was done.
Wow.
And I recorded my conversation with the attorney general. It was like 45 minutes long, inviting me up to the conference room yesterday, brought in a bunch of prosecutors. And I talked to them. They are free. They are shaken to the core on this story.
Yeah, because you busted them.
And they know they've done wrong.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. We gotta take a break. James O'Keefe, where can people go if they want to see this video and these documents?
It's projectveritas.com. That's projectveritas.com.
Okay, we'll be in touch with you going forward, James, to see how they follow through with this. And somebody just texted in from New Hampshire. Sununu better have something to say besides, you need to wear a mask. I think that you put it very well. Let's see what he has. Let's see what Governor Sununu has to say. Thank you, James O'Keefe. If you haven't tried Superbeat Soft Chews yet, you're really missing out on a great product. Superbeat Soft Chews taste like Starburst, a candy. They come wrapped in foil. You can just stick them in your pocket and eat them as you will. But they're good for you. They're healthy. They're not sugar. There's not sugar. There's not caffeine. It's just a really good, healthy product that's good for your blood pressure, good for your circulation, and it sharpens your mind. Superbeet Soft Chews combine non-GMO beets with a powerful new ingredient, grapeseed extract. The grapeseed extract used in Superbeet Chews has been clinically shown to be twice as effective at supporting normal blood pressure as a healthy lifestyle alone. Better blood pressure means more energy, just the way nature intended, without the jittery caffeine or stimulants. Now you can take just two delicious chews a day, anytime, anywhere, to get the blood pressure support you need and the energy you want. I take one in the morning before I even have my first cup of coffee, and then I usually take one when I'm just about to go on the air for the show. Right now, I don't have any. I'm sorry, VIPs.
I was just going to say, are you holding out on us? Where are the Super Beats?
We've ordered more. We always have more coming. They're coming, and I apologize for not having any for you guys today who come in. But it's so convenient. It's much more convenient than the powder. I love the powder form, but you don't have to clean anything up and you don't have to stir it and get the water and all that stuff. Just put them in your pocket when you leave the house, and they're great and they're tasty too. Two a day. That's what they recommend. Do what I did. Support your heart health with delicious Super Beats Chews. Get your Super Beats Chews today at superbeatsradio.com/Howie. And when you buy two bags, they'll throw in the third for free. If only Joe Biden had had some today in Kenosha. That's superbeatsradio.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Radio Network.
The Moonbats always say Donald Trump isn't very bright. But what about Barack Hussein Obama? Let's listen to some of his greatest hits.
I've now been in 57 states. I think one left to go. I don't know what the term is in Austrian.
The Cambridge police acted stupidly.
And there has never been any man or woman more qualified for this office than Hillary Clinton.
There are neighborhoods around the country where it is easier for a 12 or 13 year old to purchase a gun and cheaper than it is for them to get a book.
I believe in the Second Amendment. It's there written on the paper.
If we fall for, you know, a bunch of okey-doke.
A few months ago, when you were asked what's the biggest geopolitical threat facing America, you said Russia, not Al-Qaeda. You said Russia. In the 1980s or now, calling to ask for their foreign policy back.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department in the town that was running in the black, and it's because of all the recycling that was going on, so I try to keep my taxes down that way.
Hi, this is Val from Longmeadow, Mass.
Hi, this is Tony and Pietra from Haverhill, Massachusetts.
This is Myrnie in Fairfax County, Virginia, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
844-500-4242. Joining us now on the line is Kevin Frisbee. He's back doing his weekly check-in with on the markets with us. And Kevin, thanks for coming back on the air. We're happy to have you back. And tell people how they can get in touch with you if they want to talk to you or your people.
Yeah, thanks. It was great to see you guys yesterday. 800-989-9100 is how people can reach out to me. Interesting day to come back with the markets down almost 1,000 points. I hope that's not an omen. Jeez, you know?
Yeah, what's going on with the markets? I just changed my 401k allocations around because I'm concerned about the lead up to the election. I just wanted in more. I mean, I didn't move money out of the equities, but I don't want to put any more in until after the election's over and we see how things are going. What is happening here?
You know what, there's a couple things going on, and about 5 weeks ago, we positioned all of our clients into a conservative position as well to get past the election. The markets keep going up, except for today, obviously, because they don't believe the polls. The markets believe that Trump's going to win handily, and so it's kind of like a preview to what the markets may do next year, and we believe Trump's going to get reelected, and the positive stance of that is the markets should have a great year in 21-22, but our concern potentially is what's the October surprise going to be? You know, what are these shenanigans that could be pulled between now and the next 65 days? We don't know.
So you're telling people to go more conservative until the election, until we see how things are shaken out. So why did it? But yesterday we hit like an all-time high, or we regained the levels from February, and then today it's just is everybody just taking profits before the weekend, before the long weekend? Is that it? Or what else? What else could it be?
That's part of it, Howie. I mean, listen, the market has hit an all-time high. Obviously, we've gone up so far so fast since the V-shape, since the March big decline that we had, 30-something-odd percent. So, you know, naturally, if I was a day trader, let's say, with my own money, I'd be taking profits right now myself as well. I mean, why would you want to ride that out and continue for the next 60 days with an election in front of us, September, October, traditionally the worst months for the markets historically anyway. So there's a lot of headwind in front of us. So I think that's a smart thing. Some of these big traders are starting to say, we're going to cash in some chips. Not a lot. I mean, 1,000 points is not a big deal compared to the amount we're up.
Do you have any offers for our listeners today? What do you think? Anything you can give them? Any offers?
Yeah, you know what? I haven't been on in a few months, and I'm going to offer first week, and we got some offers, fresh offers coming up in the next few weeks. But I'll give my book away, Every Dime, Every Day, free copies. We've got the audiobook or the physical book. They can call up 800-989-9100.
All right, Kevin Frisbee. We'll be doing this every week from now on. 800-989-9100. If you want to talk to Kevin Frisbee or one of his people or get his free book, I'm Howie Carr.
We here at Matthews Brothers have a saying that was originally coined our first day in business. A window without glass is just a big drafty hole in the wall. You might wonder why the brothers felt it necessary to state such an obvious fact. But remember, 166 years ago, there wasn't nearly as much to talk about when it came to windows as there is today. Back then, it was pretty much, you got your wood, you got your glass, you got your putty, you got your window. Back then, windows had two jobs. Let the light in and keep everything else, wind, rain, bad guys, out. Nowadays, windows are called on to be much more than just glass holders. Today, our windows are more like transparent walls and are actually more thermally efficient than walls in homes built just 50 years ago. When you consider that a window is about 85% glass, you see why the brothers focused on it, even back then. Today, both our windows and our dual and tri-pane insulating glass units are all proudly made in Maine and are not supplied by some other manufacturer out there by the Great Divide. You can see the results of our relentless passion for making wicked awesome windows and doors, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. That's Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Can you remember any time in your life when you were starstruck?
One time I saw Peter Vesey, the NBA columnist for the New York Post. He was in the Herald sports department. I really liked his column, so I went up and introduced myself to him. Then one time there was Cousin Brucey from WABC, and I used to listen to him driving back and forth between Chapel Hill and Deerfield when I was in college. Everybody on the East Coast listened to him. I couldn't believe that I was in the presence of Cousin Brucey.
Do you ever play bridge anymore?
No, I haven't played bridge in a very long time. Nobody I know plays bridge. I think my bridge days are behind me.
Do you think you'd still be good at it?
I'm not a great bidder, but I know how to count cards. That, to me, is the essence of playing a hand of bridge, is to be able to count cards.
What is a rhino?
Rhino is a Republican in name only. Think Paul Ryan. Oh, think Mitt Romney. Think Jeff Flake.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a state job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
The investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it. I'd probably be dead if I were still working for them.
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring three things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer, and I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books, too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places.
Listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who do you consider the biggest rhino in the Republican Party?
Probably is Paul Ryan. I wish a Republican were still the speaker, but Paul Ryan was scarcely a Republican. And there was a reason he was Mitt Romney's running mate, because we had a rhino ticket in 2012.
Where did the expression, "How many more, Mr. Speaker? How many more?" come from?
That comes from the State House. There used to be a state rep who sometimes would talk about atrocities that were happening in crime. And he would get up there and he would say, "How many more, Mr. Speaker? How many more?" And I just picked it up and it became a trademark.
Where's your favorite place to go out to eat in Palm Beach?
My favorite place to go in Palm Beach is probably the Honor Bar, which used to be O Bar. And you can get a really great hamburger there, and they have a great coffee machine that brews each cup of coffee individually.
He might not be flashy, but he's there when it counts. Here's 1 minute of Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell.
For the first time in my memory, I agree with Nancy Pelosi. I am indeed the Grim Reaper when it comes to the socialist agenda that they've been ginning up over in the House.
You've watched the fight, you've watched the tactics, but here's what I want to tell you. In the very near future, Judge Kavanaugh will be on the United States Supreme Court.
Noted with great interest the Green New Deal. And we're going to be voting on that in the Senate. We'll give everybody an opportunity to go on record and see how they feel about the Green New Deal.
Well, first on the impartiality issue, do you think Chuck Schumer is impartial? Do you think Elizabeth
No.
Warren is impartial?
No.
Bernie Sanders is impartial? So let's quit the charade. This is a political exercise. Nobody is supposed to be guilty until proven innocent in the United States of America.
Look, we're at an impasse. We can't do anything until the speaker sends the papers over. So everybody enjoy the holidays.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
He's the co-sponsor of the Green New Deal. So what better time to play some of his greatest hits? Ladies and gentlemen, it's Mr. Frosty.
This is going to be a mission to save all of creation.
If you want to ignore that these changes are taking place and that they're having a dramatic impact, then you are in the right place.
Do you know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock? Do you know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock, Senator?
Well, here is the thing.
You don't. How long has your family been in Massachusetts?
We are new arrivals, and
Mr. President, American history was made last night. The Boston Patriots won the Super Bowl.
When the Second Amendment was written in order to maintain a well-regulated militia, they did not have in mind that people could purchase guns indiscriminately.
The president is acting like Pontius Pilate.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie. What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out?
Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie. I've seen a lot of anchor cupcakes in my day. Here are some of the latest network nitwits.
Tenney says, if I'm elected president, I will push for a constitutional amendment to impose term limits on all members of Congress. Correct me, there already are term limits, so what does he mean?
And what are we hearing in the background? Is that shelling?
No, Katie, you're actually hearing that here in Jerusalem, and it's actually fireworks going off right behind me.
We're in our tribes, we're in our corners most of our lives. I think we just heard some gunshots. Should we listen to that for a second, control room? Not gunshots? Okay.
Ivanka is not the second lady. She is actually, I don't think she deserves this position. She's actually a senior advisor to the president. So the idea that he would demean her specifically in that way, he shouldn't talk.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
A questionable decision in. The video shows her inside a hair salon this week in San Francisco. That is apparently against the rules. No indoor visits allowed. She's also seen not wearing a mask.
Maybe she was listening to the president who said masks are weakness, who's always encouraging people to take off masks.
You need help. You need professional help.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
I take responsibility for trusting the word of a neighborhood salon that I've been to over the years. Many times.
We have found a witch. May we burn her?
Who do you know she is a witch?
She looks like one.
As it turns out, it was a setup.
I'm just a patsy.
So I take responsibility for falling for a setup. And that's all I'm going to say on that.
And that's all I had to say about that.
Instead of claiming a setup, it would have been just as easy for the speaker to say, you know what? I messed up.
It's kind of strange coming from you.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
President Trump has actively been trying to kill New York City ever since he's been elected. He can't come back to New York. He can't. He's going to walk down the street in New York. Forget bodyguards. He better have an army if he thinks he's going to walk down the street in New York.
You know something, Princess? You are ugly when you're angry.
Unchained and unstoppable.
Mail-in voting is fraud. With the risk of fraud and coercion.
But since then,
and until this administration
hasn't proved it.
Let me talk.
Yeah, please.
The only time the narrative changed is after this administration came in. And people trying to change the rules to this methodology is reckless and dangerous. And the people are playing with fire.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Could you use a trim? Hair getting a little shaggy around the edges. Mm-hmm. Need a little frosting? Well, watch out this Labor Day weekend. Do not respond if you get a call from somebody claiming to be from a beauty salon or a barber shop. You don't want to be the next victim of a setup like Speaker Nancy Pelosi was entrapped into. This is our public service announcement. For the day. Right, Grace?
I totally agree.
Have you gotten any mysterious phone calls from people trying to set you up like they set up the Speaker of the House?
Well, most phone calls with me, it's me calling the salon, trying to get into the salon. They're not usually trying to set me up. But Howie, I have to say, based off that introduction, the sound that just I love to hear is Bill Barr. Bill Barr, he can take down anyone in a debate. Like he would be a tough competitor for even the best debater, but against Wolf Blitzer, it's not fair. Like,
Wolf Blitzer is a lot like our junior senator from Massachusetts, Ed Markey, to a battle of wits. He comes unarmed.
I'll say, wow, that was a thing of beauty. But Howie, I'm not going to waste any time during my new segment because Joe Biden is in Kenosha and it is not good. It is not good. And so what happened was, earlier this week, Trump had said he was going to go to Kenosha. Biden's team had come out and said Trump should not go. It's a distraction. It's bad.
And remember, 2 weeks ago, Joe Biden would not go to Milwaukee, even though the Democrat convention was sort of being held there.
Well, we know from Hillary Clinton, it's hard to get a Democrat to go to Wisconsin. It's just, it really goes against every fiber of their being. But Trump said he was going to go to Kenosha, which makes sense, both politically to go there because there's a lot of unrest, but also he is the president of the United States. So you can really go anywhere in the U.S. as president and say it is for XYZ. Joe Biden going is solely for politics. It's a campaign stop, basically. And it was a bad idea because some of this sound, Howie, is unbelievable. I want to start with, actually, you know what, Taylor, I'm gonna let you choose. I think the best one, or not the best one, but the worst one, is him saying he's going to be shot if he continues.
Yeah, and just keep in mind where he is and who he is speaking to in this cut.
Yeah, he's speaking to members of the community, meaning the black community here. And he's wearing a mask too, which is kind of weird. Just that he didn't take off the mask because he's much further away than 6 feet from anybody. But I guess there's more weird stuff. I haven't heard these cuts.
Oh, you're in for a treat, Howard. You're in for a treat. Let's start with the first one that's just very odd.
0.1%, which is $1,350,000,000,000, has done nothing to help anybody. 19 corporations making $1 billion apiece don't pay a single penny in taxes. I'm not going to punish anybody, but everybody should pay a fair share. I can lay out for you. I won't now because they'll shoot me.
Can we quote you on that, Mr. Vice President? You're worried about being shot in Kenosha, Wisconsin?
That is up on the same level as stand up. Who was he telling to say?
A state senator from Pennsylvania.
Who was in a wheelchair.
Yeah, who was in a wheelchair.
When he told him to stand up. It's something.
God love you, Jim.
It's stand up. God love you. It's something
Chuck,
about.
Chuck, sorry.
It's almost like he knows, almost like Michael Scott. He knows what he's not supposed to say and he can't help himself and it slips out. He also, a really interesting thing, Taylor, and I'm not sure if we have this cut yet. A woman went up and basically said that she was told that she can only ask a certain question and she was going to go off script. Let's play this cut.
Hello, my name is Portia Bennett. I'm just going to be honest, Mr. Biden. I was told to go off this paper, but I can't. You need the truth, and I'm part of the truth.
Cut the feed. Cut the feed. Get her off. Get the hook. Get the hook.
This is why they only want trained reporters, because they will take orders. You know, they will read the question on the paper.
Incidentally, on Fox, that is when the feed got cut.
I love the fact that she went off script, because I said this to Howie today. It goes from me being angry at the mainstream media to just embarrassed for them. I'm embarrassed that none of them have a little bit of journalistic curiosity to ask a legitimate question. All they can ask Joe Biden is, how are you going to spend all the money you made this past week? It's basically like saying, now that you won the Super Bowl, where are you going to go? I'm going to go to Disney. Like, these aren't real questions. So the fact that this girl went off script, he must have been like, oh my God, what is she going to ask me? But
let's go to all these cuts, though. We got a ton of cuts. Let's play cut 62 here.
And here I was then, literally 40 years later to the month, on January 17th, standing on the platform of that very same stain station.
That very same stain station? The stain station? That was on my birthday, too, by the way, January 17th.
It's not about you, Howie. Are we back on you again?
It's about a stain station.
Well, one of the most offensive things I think he said, now keep in mind, he's speaking to a primarily black audience, and he says, he goes, I think you guys know what happens when you get out of prison. So let's play this cut.
Because right now we're in a situation where you get out of prison, and I think you all know this, you get a bus ticket and $25.
This is bad. The VIPs are in shock. I think you all know this.
I've asked this question before when we've been playing cuts like this for the last few weeks. How much of this is actually going to make it onto the network newscast, the left-wing cable channels tonight?
And no disrespect, but that would be like me sitting with Hunter Biden and saying, well, you know, Coke, I mean, I'm assuming you know that Coke cost X amount. Like, you don't say that to people, you know what I mean? It's just so rude. It's like, why would they know that? He's just very obnoxious. Let's play. Oh, at one point he apologizes for not using social distancing and he gets very, very confused. This is cut. I'm not sure what the number
is.
And
I said, don't tell me things can't change. I told him about the story. Am I violating social distancing here walking up? I guess I am. Sorry. Yeah. And
Is it over? Is the cut over? Or is it going on?
He's just getting very, very confused. And he likes to use these excuses. And you guys have heard them before where he says, oh, I can't keep going, or oh, I shouldn't say that. And it's his way of getting out of finishing a thought.
My time is up.
Right. Let's just keep playing through them.
That's not right in America. Just two jobs just to be above the poverty rate, above the poverty level.
It's always two jobs. They always talk about two jobs. Remember, they always say, "I have three jobs, and they're all at McDonald's or that stuff." But when Obama is in there, or Clinton is in there, all these jobs are wonderful and they're magnificent and they're just
right.
And when Trump is in there, it's Nancy Pelosi trying to free people from job lock, right?
Right, right. No, exactly. Let's put the next one.
You know that old definition of a firefighter? God made man, and then he made a couple firefighters. You're all crazy, thanks God. I grew up in a neighborhood, either became a firefighter or a priest, and I wasn't qualified for either, so here's I am.
He sounds very out of breath, doesn't he? Everything's in the same, like, the same tone.
He is wearing the mask, and breathing in your own carbon dioxide would have that effect.
Firefighter, and he's trying to be working class Joe, right? You're a firefighter, a priest. Usually they say, you come out of a neighborhood, you're either a cop or a gangster, right? But he can't say that, so he's going to say firefighter or priest. I've never heard that one.
Is that the same neighborhood Chris Matthews grew up in?
I once was an altar boy at a mental institution here in Philadelphia. We called it Byberry. And I remember the priest said, I don't mind these people except when they touch me. And that turned me off a little bit.
Joe's from a different part of Pennsylvania. He's from Scranton.
Taylor.
Comrade Chris is from Philadelphia.
Taylor, did he tell one of the moderators to sit down at one point?
I think he did. I'm not sure if we have that cut yet.
Okay, so when we get back, we'll try to find that. But guys, Grace's News is brought to you by Toyota of Portsmouth, the house of value. I absolutely love my new RAV4 XLE. I got at Toyota of Portsmouth. You can check it out on my Twitter and Facebook. But what I loved even more than my car, which everyone knows I'm obsessed with, is this service at Toyota of Portsmouth. Everyone from sales to finance, Jim Boyle, Brad Austin, they're all such wonderful people. They'll treat you like family. Toyota of Portsmouth has a huge, sparkling, clean showroom, especially now after COVID. They're doing all of the right protocol. Everything is sparkling clean. They're located just south of the Portsmouth traffic circle off of 95. Go to toyotaofportsmouth.com or visit them at the showroom and tell them Grace sent you. It's me.
If you're thinking of replacing your carpets due to pet stains and odors, you must try Genesis 950 first. It breaks down the bonds of stains and odors so they're gone from carpets and padding for good. You can use it in a carpet cleaning machine, and it's green, so it's safe for family and pets. It's the go-to cleaner whenever you have a problem, whether you have a pet or not. My daughter doesn't have a dog, and she used it on some old carpets that she got when she moved into her new house. It did an amazing job. She couldn't believe it.
It really works on a lot of things too. It works on stovetops. I mean, the mailroom manager gave me a bottle of Genesis 950 and I'm already halfway through.
Before you purchase new carpeting, though, you must try Genesis 950. 1 gallon of industrial strength Genesis 950 makes up to 7 gallons of cleaner, and it's not just for pet stains. It's a disinfectant that kills viruses. As Grace said, it's also great for kitchens, garages, grease stains, wheels, tires, and more. Save yourself the trouble of going to the store and seeing your favorite cleaner sold out yet again. Genesis 950 is made in America, and as we like to say, buy American, support America. Order a gallon direct at genesis950.com. Enter code Howie to get more than a $10 value in savings, including free shipping and a free spray bottle with a 1 gallon purchase of Genesis 950. Go to genesis950.com. Enter code Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
The paper boy with a big microphone. Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Aviva Trattoria. From their famous chicken parm to their gluten-free menu, Aviva Trattoria has it all with locations in Marlboro, Westford, Wrentham, and Maynard. Stop in today or find them at avivatrattoria.com.
This is the Howie Carr Show, live from Chappaquiddick at the Party House. 25 years after Chappaquiddick 1969. On WHDH, News Talk 850.
Another bad song from 1969. 742-0850. We're going to take some calls this segment if you want to get on board. If you have any questions for John Farrar, the scuba diver who saw Mary Jo Kopechne's body underwater. The number again, 742-0850. We're going to start talking about the incident and everyone's perceptions. John, let me just get this straight. So now, as far as your belief is that while Ted Kennedy was walking past all these houses back towards the Party House where we're broadcasting from now, Mary Jo was still alive.
That is correct.
And she would have been alive probably for about an hour, you think?
I think that's most reasonable, and if an hour, if not longer, that's correct.
If not.
We all shop online, and now you could do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal. When you check out, just click the Apply Coupons button that pops up. Wait a few seconds for Honey to scan its database of all the working coupons on the web. Then watch your price drop. Honey works on nearly every online store, including Walmart, Target, Home Depot, Macy's, Etsy, and more. And Honey has found over $2 billion in savings for its users. That's why it has over 100,000 five-star reviews on the Google Chrome Store. It's 100% free to use and installs in seconds. Plus, it's backed by PayPal, so you know it's secure and reliable. Not using Honey is literally passing up free money. So get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/Howie. That's joinhoney.com/Howie.
President Trump is clearly ethically unfit and intellectually unprepared to be the president of the United States.
And I salute Chairman in the coming weeks, the House will hold hearings. Congresswoman Harris, Congressman. Senator Harris.
He's our president, and I would rather he not be taking something that has not been approved, especially in his age group and in his, shall we say, weight group, what is morbidly obese, they say.
So completely inappropriate in so many ways that it's almost a given. It's like a child who comes in with mud on their pants or something. That's the way it is. They're outside playing. That's what he comes in with doggy doo on his shoes, and everybody who works with him has that on their shoes too. But I only will do that if you tell me that this legislation is worthy of George Kirby's name.
This movement of moment of national anguish.
This is Mark in Williston, Vermont.
This is Marie in Somerville, Massachusetts.
This is Mike from South Attleboro, Mass. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
Today's poll question is brought to you by Genesis 950. Again, Genesis 950, sending warm thoughts to all the cars. That's me and my family after Mr. Gooner's passing. Before you replace your carpets due to pet stains, try Genesis 950. It breaks down the bonds of stains and odors from the carpet and padding. Order direct at genesis950.com. Put in code word Howie and get free shipping and a free spray bottle with a 1 gallon purchase of Genesis 950. That's a $10 savings. Taylor, what's the poll question? And first we should play the cut from Nancy Pelosi about her not guilty plea in the court of public opinion today.
No, I've been there many times. I appreciate the question. And let me just say this. I take responsibility for trusting the word of a neighborhood salon that I've been to over the years many times. And that when they said what we're able to accommodate people one person at a time, and that we can set up that time, I trusted that. As it turns out, it was a setup. So I take responsibility for falling for a setup.
That's the equivalent of, I'm sorry you feel that way. It's a non-apology apology.
At that point, the judge would say, you're asked, defendant, to either plead guilty or not guilty.
Yeah. Land the plane,
we'll
Nance.
Tell you, this is just a plea hearing. You know, the trial will be later.
Howie, I was thinking about it this morning. And remember I got that ticket when I was parked in a loading zone in Boston? I was also getting my hair done, by the way. So I feel Nancy's plight here. But I should have...
It was a setup.
I should have thought that.
A meter maid set you up.
I should have said, this is a setup. I'm not paying $100.
But Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results?
Was Nancy Pelosi set up?
Absolutely not.
Only 5% think she was.
All right. So...
You know what we have to go to right now. Taylor claims that, you know what, Taylor, I'm just going to let you say it because it's not ladylike, but go ahead.
So we think we have
a Swalwell moment.
A Swalwell moment, some live flatulence from Joe Biden. You have to listen very closely, though.
Why in God's name don't we teach history in history classes? A black man invented the light bulb, not a white guy named Edison. Okay. There's so much. Did anybody know before what recently happened?
That was a setup.
Wait, I need to hear it again, I think.
It's happened again.
A black man invented the light bulb, not a white guy named Edison. Okay? There's so much. Did anybody
And
know
Jared pointed out, he gets a little lost his train of thought, as one might if you flatulate on mic.
That was like a...
That was worse than Swalwell.
Yeah, it was. Because Swalwell's was technically, according to the Reddit threads, it was a mug being dragged across the table. Because here's what happens. If someone farts on TV, which I pray to God never happens to anyone in this room, people start to investigate. And so all of these people started getting into the theories about what happened. I came in that morning and Taylor was like, I want to break down what I think happened with the fart. I think it was a mug dragged across the table. This more sounds like it could have been a real fart. And plus, he was walking around, right?
The light bulb. Not a white guy named Edison.
This is not good.
And
this is not good.
To boot,
I just want to...
He was bending over at that exact moment.
Can I use the same joke I used with Swalwa?
Go ahead.
Do you know what Biden's new book's going to be called? The Fart of the Deal. I had to use it, y'all. Guys, we have Donald Trump Jr. coming up after the break, so I wanted to let everyone know so nobody tunes out because he's talking about his latest book, and that's going to be very exciting. But beyond Joe Biden today, Howie, did you see the Fox poll that came out about Trump, and he was tweeting
this
about
is
it?
So incredible.
He said, I don't buy this poll at all. And someone brought this up to me today, and they said, what has changed since 2016 as far as the pollsters are concerned? What are they doing differently? Because aren't they the ones who have to adjust now? They made the mistakes in 2016. Right. So why are we to trust any of these new polls?
Well, I think, how about the question that was raised earlier this week, which is why are there no post-convention polls coming out of a lot of these liberal media organizations?
Sean Davis from The Federalist tweeted that out. He said, at this same time after the DNC, there was major polls from all the networks. There was at least 7 of them, I think. And we haven't gotten any from Trump's RNC.
You know, if I can use one of their favorite words, weaponize, the liberal media are using these polls to help the Democrats. They're weaponizing them. It energizes their donating base, and it depresses, or they think it depresses us deplorables.
That's where I think they're wrong, though. I don't think the deplorables get depressed. I think they start going, you know what? I'm going to tell my son and my grandson and my cousins to all get out and vote for Trump.
I agree. We'll be right back with Donald Trump Jr. I'm Howie Carr.
Hey, Howie, I see you got a haircut again.
Yes, I did, Grace. It looks good, doesn't it?
It definitely looks better than that haircut you got a few years ago before you met the president. Remember that bad buzz cut, Howie?
Geez, you love bringing that up, don't you?
Well, I just think that your bad haircut was a true testament to the wonderful work of Dr. Hines at DiStefano Hair Restoration. Because even though you looked crazy at the time, your hair grew back, and now you look as dapper as ever.
That's true. Dr. Hines did such a wonderful job on my hair. I love waking up every day not worrying about bald spots or a dreaded comb over. I now have a thick head of hair. And the best part of it is, it's my hair. Getting a DiStefano hair restoration was the best decision I ever made.
Well, besides hiring me, right, Howie?
Like I said, Grace, it was the best decision I ever made.
You heard him, guys. Go to hairman.com to get the hair you've always wanted. Get hair like Howie's. Go to DiStefano Hair Restoration. They have 5 locations in New England, and they are open for business. That's hairman.com.
Biden might be the front runner for the Democrats, but that isn't stopping him from serving up a whole lot of gaffes. Take a listen.
I believe that the president is literally an existential threat to America for 3 reasons. One, he is a genuine threat to our...
I had permission to hug Lonnie.
He says, let's make America great again. Let's make America America again.
I think I'm either low IQ or slow, or I don't know what I am. You know, slow Joe Biden.
The thanks for the Mary and I'm going to be here a lot.
I want the press to know she pulled me close. I just want you to know, okay?
President Trump inherited an economy from Obama Biden.
By the way, he gave me permission to touch him.
They can't even figure out how to deal with the fact that they have this great division between the China Sea and the mountains in the east, in the west.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
Jim Acosta, without a doubt, wins the competition for Trump's least favorite journalist of all time. Let's listen to some of their feistier moments.
I'll tell you what, CNN should be ashamed of itself having you working for them. You are a rude, terrible person. You shouldn't be working for CNN. Should I let him have a little bit more? What do you think, Peter? Peter, should I let him have a little bit more? Sit down. I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine...
Very fake news.
I know, but aren't you...
When I raise money... Excuse me. I've watched you on television. You're a real beauty.
Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN.
All right.
And if you did it well, your ratings would be
much
better.
If I may ask one other question, Mr. President, are you worried...
That's enough.
Mr. President, what do you say to your critics who say that you're concocting a national emergency here in order to get your wall because you couldn't get it through other ways?
What do you think? Do you think I'm creating something? Ask these incredible women who lost their daughters and their sons, because your question is a very political question, because you have an agenda. You're CNN. You're fake news.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
We went to the White House for the Christmas party. In your opinion, what was the highlight?
The highlight of my trip to the White House with Grace, there were two. Number one, when we walked into Trump International Hotel, which she'd been dreaming of going to, and her eyes were wide. And then when the president actually came down the stairs, her eyes were even wider. She was so in awe of being there. I really felt like King Farouk, you know? I felt like I was giving someone a really great gift that they couldn't get otherwise.
You've had some really good interviews over the years. Which one was your favorite?
I can't really say what the best interview I ever had, but one that just occurred to me was Jesse Helms, the senator from North Carolina. I interviewed him one time, and he went to high school with my mother in Monroe, North Carolina. And the first words out of his mouth were, "Howie, I know your mother before you knew your mother."
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. James O'Keefe from Project Veritas has got another story today. He's uncovered a double voter in New Hampshire. And the attorney general of New Hampshire knew about it. And they were just sitting on it until O'Keefe
went in to their offices in Concord, and the guy has been arrested today. He voted once under his real name of Vincent Marzillo, and the other name he voted under was Helen Ashley. And they have a picture of a challenged voter affidavit. They took a picture of him, and it's a guy in drag. And the New Hampshire Democrat Party, according to James O'Keefe, put this woman up as a poll watcher for the New Hampshire. She was nominated by the New Hampshire Democrat Party to be a poll watcher or election supervisor, whatever they call it. And O'Keefe called up the chairman of the New Hampshire State Party, a guy named Ray Buckley, and they immediately withdrew the nomination. He did that after he hung up on O'Keefe. And we're gonna be following this story. It's breaking even as we talk. We're gonna be talking with someone from the Trump campaign in New Hampshire, Al Baldessaro. He's a state rep. We'll be talking to him shortly about this. And, President Trump has been talking for a long time about the voter fraud in the state of New Hampshire, because he lost the state very narrowly in 2016. And joining us now on the line is the president's son, Donald Trump Jr. He's the author of a new book, Liberal Privilege, Joe Biden and the Democrats' Defense of the Indefensible. Donald Trump Jr., thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Good to be with you, Howie. How's everything?
Very good. We're just talking about our breaking story up here in New Hampshire, where James O'Keefe of Project Veritas has discovered a double voter in New Hampshire. The guy voted once as a man and once as a woman, believe it or not. And the Democrats put him up as being one of their election supervisors. They were nominating this double voter as one of their election supervisors. And of course, once O'Keefe confronted him with it, they've dropped it. And the guy has been arrested this afternoon up in New Hampshire.
It doesn't surprise me that those are the people they would want watching the polls. I mean, it seems to be sort of their MO at this point.
Right. And Wolf Blitzer is going after the attorney general, saying, well, they're basically using the word anecdotal. Everything is anecdotal. You know, just because a guy registers as a man and then votes as a woman and then gets nominated by the party in New Hampshire, that's just an anecdote, Donald Trump Jr., right?
Obviously, it's not indicative of the systemic problem that these guys are trying to create. I mean, well, see, that is liberal privilege. That is the perfect example of it. Whether it's that, whether it's Nancy Pelosi, you know, rules for thee but not for me. Mary Antoinette over there in California yesterday with the hair salon. The liberals can get away with that. They get a full pass. They get full coverage from the media that will run cover for them and make up anecdotal stuff so that we could try to sell it, but it's not as egregious as it is. That's why I wrote the book, because Joe Biden in particular has a lot of liberal privilege. He's gotten away with murder over the last 50 years, supposedly being for blue-collar workers while destroying American manufacturing, sending our jobs abroad, sending our American dream abroad. His family has made probably hundreds of millions of dollars off of his taxpayer-funded office, and it's not just Hunter with the shady deals from China, you know, $1.5 billion from China and $30 million a year in fees. Minor details. I'm sure Joe will be really tough on China despite all that. This is the kind of stuff that's happened time and time again, and no one bothers to cover it. Things that would be totally disqualifying for Donald Trump. You know, on the left, it's like it didn't even happen. So that's why I wrote Liberal Privilege, because the media has just abdicated their responsibility to look at these people, to look into their policies, to look into their families and the shady dealings. Someone had to do it, so it was going to be me.
Isn't it amazing what that Nancy Pelosi gets busted? As you said, a total Marie Antoinette moment again after the ice cream and the Sub-Zero freezer, and she goes out there and not only doesn't apologize, she demands an apology from the hair salon owner.
Yeah.
Who's basically nearing bankruptcy because she hasn't been able to work for 6 months.
Exactly. I mean, this is someone who's supposed to be leading the Democrat Party. This is the Speaker of the House. She's so out of touch. She has no idea how ridiculous it looks. you know, that thing during, you're right, during the quarantine when she's laughing in front of her $25,000 freezer and the custom tailor-made ice creams, and she's just laughing and having a good time. I mean, what a schmuck. It's really embarrassing.
And then there's your governor. You still live in New York. That's your legal domicile, I believe. Governor Andrew.
Not for long, but yeah.
Governor Andrew Cuomo. Your reaction to his intemperate, shall we say, remarks about your father yesterday about how he's going to need an army to protect them if he goes in back to the city.
Listen, Andrew Cuomo has his big tough guy shtick. The reality, he's the biggest loser of the COVID-19 crisis. He's number 50 out of 50 in terms of any medical metric. He bungled all of these things. He killed 10,000, 11,000 elderly people by sending sick people back into nursing homes when everyone knew that the elderly and those with pre-existing conditions were the most susceptible to this virus. I mean, this guy literally has blood on his hands, but because he'll be a pretend tough guy and, you know, will say negative things about Donald Trump, you know, the media gives him a pass. They give his incompetence a pass. And yet another example of liberal privilege. The guy literally has five times the amount of death in New York than Governor Ron DeSantis does in Florida, and with an older population and a larger population, but somehow Cuomo's still the hero. He's in last place out of 50 governors, and they'll make him a hero because he'll say negative stuff about Donald Trump. I mean, the incompetence is baffling. The hypocrisy is even worse.
Yeah, I know. And these governors now are like the governor of Philadelphia, Jim Kenney. He's got Philadelphia restaurants totally locked down, just like de Blasio in New York City. And then he goes to Maryland and for an indoor meal at a restaurant, even though he's banned it in his hometown, the city that he governs. It's amazing. It really is. I mean, it is liberal privilege.
It's a big club. It's a big club, and we are not in it. You know, that should be very apparent. You know, they want to be able to establish a set of rules, but not have to live by them. Think about it this way. I mean, this is the first time in American history where you go to jail, you get fined, you get ticketed for opening your business to feed your family, but you don't for looting and burning down someone else's business. You know, the Democrats had no interest in the looting or the rioting or the violence or the anarchy until Chris Cuomo, the Fredo version, he gets on CNN and gets to talk about, oh man, guys, this is really affecting us in the polls. Maybe you have to do something. Then for the first time in 90 days, Joe Biden emerges from his borough basement and says, oh, we're going to do something about this now. Where were you for 90 days, Joe? You were tacitly accepting it because these are your voters, Joe. These are Biden voters running around looting cities, beating people on the heads with bricks, burning down buildings. You know, these aren't conservatives. If you're a conservative, you try wearing a MAGA hat in Portland right now. But if you wore a Joe Biden shirt in the most conservative city in the country, people would leave you alone. You'd be just fine. Because the Democrats, they're pushing their hate. They don't want to solve any of these problems. Joe Biden's out in Wisconsin today talking about race. You know, it's nice when he can get a complete sentence out. But he's talking about race, but he didn't do anything when he had a 50-year career in D.C. He did nothing to help the racial divide. It's not like he wasn't the vice president to the first African-American president. He could have done something, but he chose not to.
Donald Trump,
he would rather campaign on problems than solve them.
Let me play a cut for you, Donald Trump Jr. This is Biden this afternoon in Kenosha, Wisconsin, and he's speaking to a predominantly black audience. And listen to what he says. Cut 63.
Because right now we're in a situation where you get out of prison, and I think you all know this, you get a bus ticket and $25.
So he's telling the black audience they know what it's like to get out of prison. What would happen if your father said something like that?
It would be, you know, the end of the world. And speaking of getting out of prison, Donald Trump is the guy that got prison reform done. Donald Trump is the guy that got the First Step Act done. Donald Trump is the guy that pushed and got Opportunity Zone legislation done to help the inner cities. Look at Joe Biden's racial policies. I cover them thoroughly in the book because you need to. He gets a total pass. It's been a disaster. His policies for that community have been a disaster. He chose not to do anything, again, because it's much easier to campaign on someone's problem than it is to actually solve it. And the Democrats have made a cottage industry of telling everyone that they're a victim but not doing anything to actually solve the problems and then expecting them to vote for them again in 4 years. That's their MO. That's what they've done.
Isn't Governor Cuomo in the past said that gun owners and pro-life New Yorkers were free to leave the state and they weren't welcome? Now he wants all you guys not to come back to New York. It's going to be pretty lonely isn't it?
It is, and that's why U-Haul, there's a line around the corner for people leaving this state, because the people who have produced are sick of being vilified. They're sick of being treated like crap, and then they say, hey, guess what? We're going to raise your taxes even more because we've been running these cities in an incompetent fashion for decades, these states. Look at what's going on as it relates to corona. New York State wants X billion dollars. It's not to fix problems with corona. It's to fix 50 years of failed Democrat policies that have destroyed the state. This is nothing to do with corona. And then they're upset that they won't get them, because why would the federal government, why would responsible people bail out a city who's literally just sitting idly by, watching people vandalize, watching them burn down, not doing anything, nothing to stop it from happening? They can get away with it again because of liberal privilege, but I think real people are watching Andrew Cuomo as they're sitting watching New York get destroyed, watching Bill de Blasio as New York gets destroyed, watching the people who are actually paying the taxes that fund these ridiculous overinflated Democrat budgets in these cities, and they're leaving because they've had enough, and I understand it.
I'm going to ask you a tough question. Who is a worse leader, Cuomo or de Blasio?
Honestly, I mean, they're both really bad, but I don't think anyone's worse than Bill de Blasio. I mean, you couldn't come up with a plan to destroy a city as effectively as Bill de Blasio had by trying to lead. It's actually not possible. Cuomo's done some disasters for the state, but in terms of the city and leadership and just abject incompetence, I got to call a spade a spade and give it to de Blasio. No one is that incompetent.
Donald Trump Jr., thank you for being with us. The title of your new book is Liberal Privilege, and it's a good read. I'm looking forward to dipping into it this weekend. Thank you, Donald Trump Jr. And hey, and tell your father about what's going on in New Hampshire. We tweeted at you for that. He's gonna enjoy that. It proves everything he says about New Hampshire.
I'll do that, guys.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Okay. We'll be right back with one of the Trump chairmen in the state of New Hampshire to talk about this, Project Veritas. The Eden Pure Thunderstorm Super Air Purifier sold out in 2 minutes last week with our special. But Eden Pure is continuing the Thunderstorm sale for Howie Carr Show listeners. Thunderstorm is a super compact, super powerful air purifier. You can hold it in your hand. You just plug it into your electrical outlet or into your car by USB cable to purify the air. The Thunderstorm Super Pure Air Purifier works like a real thunderstorm. It quietly sends out super oxygen and negative ions to destroy 99.9% of all air pollution, including germs, allergens, and odors. We've been using it in our studio, and all the staff notices a big difference. It makes the room smell fresh like it would outside after a thunderstorm. They could have used some in Kenosha today after Joe Biden got through there. It quickly eliminates all odors, including cigarette and pet odors. Vets, veterinarians, and real estate agents are using it now to get rid of odors they could never remove before, including smoking odors, which are the toughest of all to get rid of. For protection from germs and to get rid of stubborn, lingering odors, you need the Thunderstorm. The Thunderstorm air purifier covers up to 400 square feet, has no filters to replace, and runs super quiet. The small Thunderstorm is 100 times more powerful than the big noisy air purifiers that'll cost you over $700. The Thunderstorm is now on sale for just $97, but with Howie's big discount, it will be just $87. Use code word Howie at checkout. The more you buy, the more you save. If you buy two, you save $20. If you buy three, you save $30. That's the way it works. Just put in code word Howie. EdenPure.com. Your problem room will no longer be a problem. I'm Howie Carr.
A nightmare to liberals everywhere. He's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by J.T. Kelly Real Estate Broker. He helped Carolyn Carr buy a house during COVID, and he can help you too. Contact him at 1-800-364-9200. That's 1-800-364-9200.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020, but the main one is Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump, knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president.
I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, I never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be? I'd be the world's worst.
Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. I said, what are we? Are we allowed to grow too? Okay. Now, are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide that bald spot, folks. I work harder. Doesn't look bad. Hey, we're hanging in.
I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year because I've destroyed her political career and now I won't get a chance to run against her and I would have loved it. I don't want to knock out all of the good stuff and end up with somebody that's actually got talent. That would be terrible.
With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show, and for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a two-year contract. You just order online. Set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more. All for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey, you like movies about gladiators?
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
I'm working for you.
I'm to be honest, I don't know the sexual orientation of my staff.
When Dick Durbin called me, I had tears of rage when I heard about this experience in that meeting. And for you not to feel that hurt, tears of rage.
Would you just stop being so dramatic?
I'm a big believer that if this country hasn't broken your heart, then you don't love her enough.
This is Jeff in Woodstock, Connecticut.
This is Laura Benner in South Burlington, Vermont.
This is Jimmy Mack in Falmouth, Massachusetts. And this is The Howie Carr Show.
How did they know you voted twice?
Because I went to in Newport. You can get New Hampshire. I don't know about Vermont, but New Hampshire, you can get a picture ID to vote. Instead of showing your license, say you don't have a license or some other picture ID, you can get a voter. And I went there as hell to get it.
That's James Marzello. He's from New Hampshire. He's been arrested this afternoon. He voted as James Marzello, and he also voted as Helen Ashley. And we just tweeted out a picture from his contested affidavit where they take a picture, a snapshot of you. We tweeted it out. If you want to follow me at Howie Carr Show, you can see the picture. And it's going to be a breaking story. Joining us now on the line is Representative Al Baldassaro. He's a personal friend of the president. He was up there with him in Manchester. And he's the chairman, one of the chairmen of the campaign to reelect the president. Representative Baldassaro, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show. What do you think about this story that James O'Keefe has put out from Project Veritas?
Well, he's just one of a few, Howie. But first of all, thank you for having me on. He's one that got caught, and I wonder how many more out there that didn't get caught.
Yeah.
He's a real turd.
Yeah, I know. Well, you know, there were thousands of people that voted in 2016 with out-of-state driver's licenses. And 6 months later, I believe probably over 1,000 of them hadn't switched over to New Hampshire driver's licenses. So you have to assume that they weren't on the level, Al. Why weren't there 1,000 prosecutions rather than 10 or 20?
Well, because I know about 7 or 8 cases right now have been prosecuted in New Hampshire just within the last year and a half. I mean, you're talking, you know, they can only do so many at a time. We only have so many lawyers, you know, on the adjutant general, adjutant staff, the attorney general's staff.
Yeah. So what is, I know the president probably talks to you about this voter fraud situation up there. I mean, you've tightened up the same day registrations, but there's still a lot of potential for fraud, isn't there, at the polling places on election day?
You know, a couple elections ago, we did the cards we sent out to all the, voters. We had like about over 10,000 of them came back, you know, and not at that address. You know, and of course, some were students and other stuff that are not non-residents in college, but they're voting in New Hampshire. We think we have it fixed where where there's fines and other stuff that goes along with it. They have to register their car. They have to get a New Hampshire license, you know, and become they 60 days. There's the fines and everything goes with it.
Mm-hmm. So you think President Trump is going to carry New Hampshire this time around, Al?
Well, there's no doubt in my mind. I can tell the enthusiasm, the motivation, the volunteerism is unbelievable here in New Hampshire. And we've been training people all around the country, virtual training, for poll watchers, poll workers, lawyers, everything been going on.
Yeah, I think, I told this to the president himself, and I'm sure you have too. If they keep those colleges shut down, it really increases his chances of winning the state, doesn't it?
Oh, big time, because then we don't have to worry about them trying to go in and bust them into,
right.
You know, and give them slices of pizza to go vote.
Right. Don't have to worry about Hanover, Durham, Plymouth, Keene, all the places. Representative Al Baldessaro, thanks for being with us. We appreciate it, and keep us informed about what's going on in the Granite State. I'm Howie Carr.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300. And now, another minute of Madam Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
But, again... Don't
you have these wings, AOC and her group on one side?
It's like five people. They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame. Except we don't say sesame, we say open Biden. But no, I because we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican. 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
And now, some of my favorite fake Indian cuts of all time.
Oh, la, 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 la. I'm not going to ask you for your favorite curse word. Actually, I am. Do you have a favorite curse word?
Poop.
Poop? that's a goody two-shoes favorite
not.
Curse word
no,
if I ever heard one.
Are you kidding? Have you ever seen a woman like me look you straight in the face after you finish some long explanation of something and then just said, poop?
Hold on a sec. I'm going to get me
a beer.
I am not sure what she's talking about as far as a rally with...
It was a rally in Bern, organized by... is that you have to figure out who you are. I grew up in a family that was barely hanging on to the ragged edge of the middle class. And my Aunt Bee has walked by that picture at least 1,000 times, remarked that her father, my papa, had high cheekbones like all of the Indians do.
Listening to the Howie Carr Show.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day. Once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of 3 whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. And now, some of my favorite fake Indian cuts of all time.
I'm not going to ask you for your favorite curse word. Actually, I am. Do you have a favorite curse word?
Poop.
Poop? That's a goody two-shoes curse word if I ever heard one.
Are you kidding? Have you ever seen a woman like me look you straight in the face after you finish some long explanation of something and then just said, poop?
Hold on a sec. I'm going to get me... a beer.
I am not sure what she's talking about as far as a rally with...
It was a rally in Bern, organized by... is that you have to figure out who you are. I grew up in a family that was barely hanging on to the ragged edge of the middle class. And my Aunt Bee has walked by that picture at least 1,000 times, remarked that her father, my papa, had high cheekbones like all of the Indians do.
Jim Acosta, without a doubt, wins the competition for Trump's least favorite journalist of all time. Let's listen to some of their feistier moments.
I'll tell you what, CNN should be ashamed of itself having you working for them. You are a rude, terrible person. You shouldn't be working for CNN. Well, should I let him have a little bit more? What do you think, Peter? Peter, should I let him have a little bit more? Sit down. I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine...
Very fake news.
I know, but aren't you...
When I raise money... Excuse me. I've watched you on television. You're a real beauty.
Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN. All right. And if you did it well, your ratings would be much better.
If I may ask one other question, Mr. President, are you worried...
That's enough.
Mr. President, what do you say to your critics who say that you're concocting a national emergency here in order to get your wall because you couldn't get it through other ways?
What do you think? Do you think I'm creating something? Ask these... incredible women who lost their daughters and their sons, because your question is a very political question, because you have an agenda. You're CNN. You're fake news.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
I'm the Vice President of the United States.
Love him or hate him, Joe Biden's here for the long haul, but we can't get enough of his gaffes. Here's the best of Uncle Joe speaking before he thinks.
We choose truth over facts.
When the stock market crashed, Franklin Roosevelt got on television.
Make sure you have the record player on at night.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
Okay, all right. Well, you can frack with me later, okay?
The teachers are recon. I'm married to a teacher. My deceased wife is a teacher.
And Corn Pop was a bad dude.
I can tell you, and I've known 8 presidents, 3 of the minimum.
If you agree with me, go to Joe 30330 and help me.
Had over 40 kids shot at Kent State on a beautiful lawn.
I love this place. Look, what's not to like about Vermont in terms of the beauty of it?
I said something that was not meant the way I said.
I mean, what is it that I said wrong?
I want to be clear. I'm not going nuts. Anyway, my time's up. I'm sorry.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. buyraycon.com/Howie.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure. No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And
better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
A questionable decision and new video causing grief for House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. The video shows her inside a hair salon this week in San Francisco. That is apparently against the rules. No indoor visits allowed. She's also seen not wearing a mask.
Maybe she was listening to the president who said masks are weakness, who's always encouraging people to take off masks.
You need help. You need professional help.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
I take responsibility for trusting the word of a neighborhood salon that I've been to over the years many times.
We have found a witch, may we burn,
huh? Who do you know she is a witch?
She looks like one. Yes,
yes. As it turns out, it was a setup.
I'm just a patsy.
So I take responsibility for falling for a setup. And that's all I'm going to say on that.
And that's all I had to say about that.
Instead of claiming a setup, it would have been just as easy for the speaker to say, you know what, I messed up.
It's kind of strange coming from you.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
President Trump has actively been trying to kill New York City ever since he's been elected. He can't come back to New York. He can't. He's going to walk down the street in New York. Forget bodyguards. He better have an army if he thinks he's going to walk down the street in New York.
You know something, Princess? You are ugly when you're angry.
Unchained and unstoppable.
Mail-in voting is fraught with the risk of fraud and coercion.
But since then,
and until this
haven't proved it.
Let me talk.
Yeah, please.
The only time the narrative changed is after this administration came in. And people trying to change the rules to this methodology is reckless and dangerous. And the people are playing with fire.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
844-500-4242. People are saying, is that James Marzilli, the perv in the Prius, who's voting in New Hampshire? If I called him James Marzello, you know who I was thinking of. But his name is Vincent Marzello, M-A-R-Z-E-L-L-O. You may know him better as Helen Ashley. He's a distinguished New Hampshire Democrat, and he's under arrest this afternoon for allegedly double voting. And we tweeted out his picture, and people are frightened who have opened, who have looked at the picture. Don't let it scare you. We don't know.
You better watch your microaggressions.
We don't know how he's identifying today as he was lugged by the New Hampshire State Police. Anyway. People are also telling me that Durham is teeming with students today. The University of New Hampshire is open. But, you know, it's a long way. It's 2 months till Election Day, and I would bet that they won't be open in 2 months. That's my alma mater, the University of North Carolina, tried to open up, and somebody tested positive. It could have been a false positive, but they sent everybody home. And I'm assuming they're keeping the tuition. That's the scam. If this were a pizza shop running this kind of scam, they'd be calling out the bunco squad. But since it's higher education, they can somehow get away with it. 844-500-4242. Time now for the chump line.
Crying out loud, can we get Biden back in the basement and back on the oxygen? My God.
We're looking for another sound cut of him. He says that he was in grade school when Bull Connor, the police commissioner of Birmingham, turned the fire hoses on the black demonstrators. That would be in 1965. He was 21, 22 years old. So was he in the sixth grade when he was 22 years old? Is that what he's saying? We're looking for that cut right now.
I was against Joe Biden before I was against Joe Biden.
Joe Biden was for mandatory masks before he was against mandatory masks. He was against fracking before he was for fracking. He was for gun confiscation before he was against gun confiscation. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer. This week, remembering when popes used to proclaim a special dispensation allowing Catholics to forego normally required observances without fear of eternal damnation. Apparently, this power also rests with governors, mayors, and other assorted solons. Next, we'll be able to buy indulgences as well.
Howie, Joe Biden calling. Come on, man. I'm so excited they picked Mike Wallace's son to be the first moderator. I'm going to go out on stage and say, stand up, Chuck. Oh, God love you. Let's all stand up for Chuck. I mean it.
Did you see who the third moderator is? It's somebody I'd never even heard of him, named Scully. And this is from Scully's Wikipedia page. I'm sure it's been deleted by now, but somebody got a save of it. He served as an intern with Senator Joe Biden and in Senator Ted Kennedy's media affairs office. How can you have an intern for Joe Biden being asking the questions? And whoever heard of this guy anyway, by the way, Steve Scully, who the hell is he?
You know, I think if Joe Biden had lived, he would have made a pretty good candidate.
Oh God, it's just crazy that he was out there. I want to know if he met with Jacob Blake Sr., the father, because you should see his social media. He mentions everything but the protocols of the Elders of Zion. I mean, talk about anti-Semitism running amok.
Is Governor Cuomo slow or something? Trump needs an army to come to New York. He's got the army.
I know, and apparently the NYPD would be volunteering in by the hundreds to defend him if he ever needed that. The people who need an army to defend them in New York City are the voters, the taxpayers, the residents of New York City. And you know what? They're fleeing. I'm just getting text messages today. A guy just texted me. He said, I left Brooklyn last night and I'm in Miami, not looking back. Just remember to vote Republican now that you're in the Sunshine State.
Hey, Howie, these fraud against the elderly cases are getting out of control. But in this case, she got exactly what they promised.
You know, that's it. They go after the elderly people. You know, the older you are, the more likely you are to get one of these scam calls. And Nancy Pelosi, I guess by her own account, is saying she was scammed. It was a setup.
What are the chances the San Francisco salon that Nancy Pelosi visited will be the subject of an IRS tax audit?
Tell me about it. As someone who has been the subject of DOR audits, especially in the state of Massachusetts when the Democrats were running it, but you're You're absolutely right. You know, another unintended consequence, they decided to lift the bans on hair salons in L.A., in Southern California, after she was busted. I mean, they did. It's still only open 25 or 50%, but everybody in Southern California is really happy that this happened in San Francisco, because now they can get a haircut or a blow dry.
Howie, when did Pelosi start using the Marion Barry excuse? The bleepity bleep bleep salon set me up.
I listened to that this morning and I said, we don't need to put that on the show, because all it is But that was Mary. Yeah, Marion Barry used the same excuse. The bleep, the rhymes with witch, set me up.
So the Botox queen thinks it's unfair. She was caught in a salon coloring her gray hair. This old broad is such a fraud. She resorted to blaming the salon in her despair.
Not her despair, though. She's just outraged. I mean, this is what Donald Trump Jr. was talking about, liberal privilege. You know, you get busted. You can't even deny the video. You know, you're in a place you shouldn't be, and you're not wearing a mask. After you've been criticizing the President of the United States for not wearing a mask, and what do? Do you humbly apologize and show remorse and contrition? No. You demand an apology from the hair salon operator that you basically shook down to get them to violate the stupid ordinances. And then the mayor of San Francisco blames it on Trump. How predictable was that?
Hi, Howie. Governor Patrick calling. I wish I could time travel to the set of a civil action just to see the look on your formerly fat face when I tell you that Ed Markey would end the Kennedy dynasty and that a civil action would end your movie career. It'd be like telling Joe Biden there's no tapioca left. We're going to be fine.
Let's get your facts straight, as Mike Dukakis used to say. Governor Patrick. I was in a movie called Gentleman from Boston after that. I was the talk show host. I was written into it because the plot didn't make any sense. I became what they used to call in Greek mythology, Deus ex machina, the god out of the machine, to explain everything, because the plot didn't make any sense.
Hello, Howie. Joe Kennedy calling. I'm not worried about my future at all. Biden wins the presidency, Warren goes into a cabinet post, my family unlocks the door with the closet I'm in. Thank you.
You know, that would conceivably happen. I mean, you would think that Charlie Parker would like to flee the state, but the fact is they've changed the law so many times about how you fill a Senate vacancy. Under the current law, I guess this is the third variation in the last 15 years, you have to, he can appoint somebody, the governor, to fill the seat, but you have to have an election or a primary election and then another election within 60 or 120 days. So he'd be giving up the governorship to be a senator for 4 or 5 months.
That was your last chump line message. Thank you for calling Howie Carr, you chump.
On the other hand, maybe he thinks that the voters are so stupid that they would elect him for destroying the economy. And he's taking more bows today, by the way. We'll get to him in the final hour of the show today. He's taking bows, talking about how great he's done on the economy. It's like he doesn't think anybody can read the unemployment numbers or doesn't drive by their favorite restaurant and see the gone sign, the sold, gone out of business, won't be reopening. He thinks he's doing a great job. He really does. All right, that's it for the Chump Line. The Chump Line is the recorded voicemail message service of the Howie Carr Show. You can call and leave a message at any hour of the day or night. Not any hour of the day or night, excuse me. I keep making that mistake. Between 1 and 5 p.m. every weekday, you can leave a message on the Chump Line, 1 and 5 p.m. And the number to call is 844-500-4242, 844-500-4242. Press 2 for the Chump Line. Leave your message. We may or may not play it at this time. Each weekday. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer. This week, remembering when popes used to proclaim a special dispensation allowing Catholics to forego normally required observances without fear of eternal damnation. Apparently, this power also rests with governors, mayors, and other assorted solons. Next, we'll be able to buy indulgences as well. And if you want to hear more Chump Line messages that didn't make the air today, we have Chop Chumps. It's a podcast. Get it at 7 o'clock every weeknight, wherever you get your Howie Carr Show podcast.
I was against Joe Biden before I was against Joe Biden.
Yeah, I think I was always against Joe Biden, too. He was always kind of a pathetic figure. As I've said before, he was running in 1972 against a guy named Caleb Boggs. He was the incumbent Republican senator. He was 63 years old, and it was portrayed as he was terribly over the hill. And Joe Biden was the young whippersnapper who was so with it. And now Joe Biden is 15 years older than Caleb Boggs was when he was defeated for being too old. I'm Howie Carr.
He's suave, he's debonair, he's Howie Carr.
Alexander Hamilton said, "Those who stand for nothing will fall for anything." This is Toby from Cape Gunworks. When our founding fathers drafted the Second Amendment, there was no question of its meaning. Today, if you have questions, come to Cape Gunworks for some advice, training, or to send a few rounds downrange. We have a fully stocked pro shop with a huge selection of guns, crossbows, archery, classes, rentals, a 15-lane range, and a friendly staff. Come on down to Cape Gunworks, Airport Road, Hyannis, or capegunworks.com.
AmeriClean Sanitizing is providing state-of-the-art sanitation for your home or business. Using the HaloSil fogging system, it is able to kill 428 different viruses, including COVID. Hospitals have been using the HaloSil fogging system for years, and now you can too. The fog sanitizes everything, including keyboards, under the desk, and even HVAC systems. To schedule an appointment or learn more, go to AmeriCleanSanitizing.com. Take a look at their videos at AmeriCleanSanitizing.com and see how easy it is to kill the virus.
Joe Biden doesn't have time for malarkey, and he also doesn't have a lot of time for geography. Take a listen.
The people of Nevada are watching, and I'm going to be out there seeing them very soon. Tonight, though, we just heard from the first two of 50 states. It's important that Iowa and Nevada have spoken, but look, we need to hear from Nevada and South Carolina and Super Tuesday states and beyond.
And Biden doesn't know the difference between Iran and Iraq. He's gotten it wrong four times.
We tried it in Iraq. It's not working, so now we're going to try, in Iran? Excuse me. We tried in Ukraine.
He always gets the name wrong.
I love this place. Look, what's not to like about Vermont in terms of the beauty of it? And what a neat town. This is sort of a scenic, beautiful town. I like Keene a lot.
How many times has he missed it? He's in Iowa. It's great to be in the great state of Ohio. And they say, Joe, you're in Iowa.
How many unsafe bridges you still have here in the state of Ohio? Iowa. And I was just in Ohio because they have more.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
Brace yourself, guys. Here is 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
I myself have always been for lowering the voting age to 16. I think it's really important to capture kids when they're in high school, which was a very amiable conversation, I guess you would say, not amicable.
That they wanted their voices to be heard.
I don't think our colleague is anti-Semitic. I think she has a different experience in the use of words. That's not the total package, but there are some of the major points of discussion, I would hope, from sea to shining sea, because they did not getting paid 163, was it 163 Republicans voted no.
Wisdom from the kitchen of the Willard Hotel, yes, ma'am.
The president either doesn't know what he's talking about or doesn't want to know what he's talking about.
This is Chris in Rochester, Mass.
This is Mark in Nashville, New Hampshire.
This is Lorna in Truckstown, Pennsylvania. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
Today's poll question is brought to you by Genesis 950, sending warm thoughts to all the cars after Mr. Gooner's passing. Before you replace your carpets due to pet stains, try Genesis 950. It breaks down the bonds of stains and odors from the carpet and padding. Order direct at genesis950.com, put in code word Howie, and get free shipping and a free spray bottle with a one-gallon purchase of Genesis 950. That's a $10 savings. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Was Nancy Pelosi set up?
No.
95% say no.
Yeah. By the way, speaking of Mr. Gooner, there's a story in the front page of the Wall Street Journal. You know what another big scam is now, other than setting up old ladies to go to hair salons? They're selling pets, and then they don't deliver the pets because the kennels have all been emptied out because everybody wanted a dog, and they have a picture of a pug. That's one of the biggest scams going. A pug named Dash. And guess what? You order Dash the pug? No Dash the pug. He's gone.
He's Dash dashed.
Yes. But they're running scams too for Cocker Spaniels and King Charles Spaniels that are, bred like Golden Doodles and all that. It's a pretty interesting story, but watch out. Nancy Pelosi's probably ordering a pug right now online. She's very scammable. Let's listen to Joe Biden talk about his career. He was 21, 22 years old when Bull Connor turned the fire hoses on the black protesters. 22 years old. Listen.
But when Bull Connor, I was in grade school, when Bull Connor took those fire hoses and dogs on those black women going to church in their Sunday best and little kids having the skin ripped off them by these high-powered fire hoses.
I was in grade school, he said. Joe Biden, once again, has come unstuck in time. Or maybe he's just seeing things that didn't happen, kind of like Bill Clinton. Remember when I remember them black churches being burned down when I was a boy. Only there weren't any black churches being burned down in Arkansas when he was a boy.
Listen. Boy, after his convention, he really, really made inroads.
He hasn't. Not at all.
No, I'm not serious. I'm being. It should give you a little bit of confidence.
Wow, that drives Grace crazy when he starts whispering like that. It's scared. I think it scared the crowd too. It was just really weird. It was. It was like something out of a horror movie, like Freddy Krueger. Let me hear that one again.
Boy, after his convention, he really, really made inroads.
He hasn't. Not at all.
No, I'm not serious. I'm being. It should give you a little bit of confidence.
Thank God for social distancing, because he would be saying that so closely to someone's ear if it were. He was in somebody's face.
Boy, and then he was breathing heavily at the same time he was whispering. It was like it was like somebody calling up in the old days when they used to call, instead of trolling people online, they would call you up and. Just start breathing heavily.
While we have time, I did enhance the audio in the flatulence clip so we can get a definitive listen.
Okay.
A black man invented the light bulb, not a white guy named Edison. Okay?
Come on! We'll be right back with John Heinerracker from Powerline Blog. I'm Howie Carr. I recently had a dental emergency, and where did I go? Perfect Smiles. I've said this before.
But this reminded me again of what a perfectionist Dr. Houghton is. He is a veneer engineer, a world-class dental artist. Being on TV, it's important that I look my best. Dr. Houghton did that for me, and he can do it for you, too. Right now, when a lot of people don't want to go into the city, Perfect Smiles is conveniently located in Nashua, New Hampshire, and parking is free. I was impressed to see all the state-of-the-art safety protocols that Perfect Smiles has taken since the virus. You'll feel safe and confident when you visit Perfect Smiles. Call 1-844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 1-844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, or go to HowieCarrShow.com and click on the Perfect Smiles banner. You can also see my video at PerfectSmiles.com. Perfect Smiles. Change your smile. Change your life.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey, do you like movies about gladiators?
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
I'm sorry, working someone working for you?
I'm to be honest, I don't know the sexual orientation of my staff.
When Dick Durbin called me, I had tears of rage when I heard about this experience in that meeting. And for you not to feel that hurt, tears of rage, tears of rage.
Would you just stop being so dramatic?
I'm a big believer that if America... if this country hasn't broken your heart, then you don't love her enough.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now, when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie. What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out? Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie. The Moonbats always say Donald Trump isn't very bright. But what about Barack Hussein Obama? Let's listen to some of his greatest hits.
I've now been in 57 states. I think one left to go. I don't know what the term is in Austrian.
The Cambridge police acted stupidly.
And there has never been any man or woman more qualified for this office than Hillary Clinton.
There are neighborhoods around the country where it is easier for a 12 or 13-year-old to purchase a gun and cheaper than it is for them to get a book.
I believe in the Second Amendment. It's there written on the paper.
If we fall for, you know, a bunch of okey-doke.
A few months ago, when you were asked what's the biggest geopolitical threat facing America, you said Russia, not Al-Qaeda. You said Russia. In the 1980s are now calling to ask for their foreign policy back.
Mike Bloomberg is spending millions of dollars on all of his campaign ads, but we put together some of our favorite Bloomberg clips, and guess what, Mike? This one's totally free.
I think we disproportionately stop whites too much and minorities too little.
To be a farmer, it's a process. So you dig a hole, you put a seed in, you put dirt on top, add water, up comes the corn. Then we had 300, you could learn that.
Donald Trump is the world's biggest schoolyard bully.
Big gay ice cream is the best.
The Communist Party wants to stay in power in China, and they listen to the public. When the public says, I can't breathe the air, Xi Jinping is not a dictator. He has to satisfy his constituents, or he's not going to survive.
He's not a dictator?
No, he has a constituency to answer to.
I'm ready to get to work, so let's get it on.
I would be 79 years old when I took office. To start a 4-year job, maybe an 8-year job at age 79, may not be the smartest thing to do.
Why did you say what you said in that 2015 speech?
Um...
live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. One of the best blogs out there is powerlineblog.com, and it's handled by some guys that were lawyers in Minneapolis. I think some of them may still be. And John Heinderacker is one of them. And I wanted to just check in with him. He wrote a piece the other day about the Democrats seem to be preparing the field like they do with artillery before a battle to get us all ready for massive voter fraud. And I don't know any other way to describe the thing on HBO with the Axios guy or the Bloomberg guy, whoever he was, saying that it was going to appear that Trump is a landslide winner on election night, but by Sunday, Joe Biden will have won when all the votes are counted. John Heinderacker, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show. Pretty amazing video.
Hi, Howie.
Isn't that amazing video?
It's unbelievable. This guy described as a top Democratic data and analytics firm telling Axios, which is a Democratic Party-leaning website,
right,
that on election day it's going to look like President Trump got reelected, maybe in a landslide, but don't give up the ship, right? I think what you said is exactly right, Howie. This is battle space preparation. The Democrats are trying to prepare us for the idea that this election's not going to be over until Joe Biden wins. And it may look like President Trump has won, and he may have most of the votes on election day, but they are going to keep counting and counting and counting, potentially for weeks. This guy says it could be weeks of counting ballots, and sooner or later, if you count long enough, Joe Biden is going to be ahead.
Yeah, there's a famous scene in Key Largo where Johnny Rocco, played by Edward G. Robinson, is talking about the old days back in Chicago, and he talks about how we just kept counting the votes until it turned out right. And we got to play that cut. Actually, we got to find that. We have it somewhere. But that's what they're doing. They're saying that that's what they want to do.
It's clearly what they have in mind. And you probably saw, Howie, there was something in the Washington Post where they've got some people like wargaming out different scenarios for the election. And their conclusion was that the only scenario where we don't have basically civil war breaking out is if Joe Biden wins in a landslide.
Yeah.
Right. On any other scenario, look for civil war.
And they were running. They were including in these stories tweets that Donald Trump was going to send out. I mean, this is like that fake headline in the Boston Globe in 2016: Donald Trump elected, and the economy crashes, and there are all these riots, and international tension. They're just making stuff up. You know?
And it's basically a threat, Howie. Vote for our guy or your city will burn down. You know, we'll burn it down. You know, that's really, I think, the implicit threat. But a lot of what's going on here, Howie, obviously has to do with this whole push for what I call voting by junk mail. And already I've got emails from people who say, you know, look, the state of Minnesota sent me a ballot. It didn't send me a ballot. Sent a ballot to my house, addressed to a person I've never heard of, who has never lived in this house because I built it. And I don't know why I'm, you know, but if that person wanted to, he could fill out the ballot and send it back. There are countless thousands of ballots just being blindly mailed out. And I think the Democrats' calculation is that Republicans are honest and they won't cheat, but they know that their own voters,
right,
in many cases will cheat. Here in Minnesota, there's a requirement, if you're going to vote by mail or by absentee, that the signature has to be witnessed by a third party, right?
Mm-hmm.
Somebody else. Well, they did away with that requirement. They brought a lawsuit, and just for this election, that requirement has been suspended. So there's no check at all. If a ballot comes to your house, addressed to God knows who, fill it out, send it in.
In New Hampshire this afternoon, they arrested a Democrat Party campaign ballot inspector. He admitted to James O'Keefe from Project Veritas that he had voted twice in 2016, once as a man and once as a woman.
Yeah, apparently the standards of authentication are not too high. This guy voted under the name of Helen somebody.
Helen Ashley.
Not raising any questions.
Yeah, we don't know if he was appointed as a ballot inspector under the name of his male name or under his female name. Listen, this is Johnny Rocco talking 75 years ago about how to win an election like the Democrats are planning to win it on November the 3rd.
Get my boys to bring the voters out. And then count the votes over and over again until they added up right and he was elected.
There it is.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you could just imagine this, Howie. I mean, it really is a scary scenario that they're trying to prepare us for. The election is over, but wait, it's not over. You know, days go by, potentially weeks go by. Mail-in ballots are being opened and examined and argued over. Does it count? Does it not count? Total fiasco. It could make the hanging chads look like, you know, a normal election.
Yeah. How about this? One of your cohorts of the Powerline blog just mentioned this. People were checking out this guy, Steve Scully, who's going to be one of the debate moderators. And he's from C-SPAN. And it turns out that he was an intern for Senator Joe Biden and then worked in Senator Ted Kennedy's media affairs office. How the hell did he get to be a debate moderator?
I do not understand it, Howie. I assume he disclosed that. I mean, what's the process? I don't know. This kind of thing keeps happening over and over and over again, and I can't understand it.
I know. And I want to bounce another couple of things off. I liked your column saying that you thought Minnesota was in play, and I saw those six mayors from not from the Minneapolis-St. Paul area, but further north, who came out for Donald Trump, all Democrat mayors. And I like the quote from one of them. I heard him say, "I haven't seen a real Democrat in 30 years." You know?
Yeah, Howie, that is a great quote. You know, the Democratic Party here in Minnesota is called the Democrat Farmer Labor Party,
right?
DFL. Well, there are no farmers left in that party. There are no laborers left in that party. And the mayors you're talking about are from the Iron Range in northern Minnesota. And these folks have figured out that the Democrats are just trying to shut them down, to put them out of business, end the mining that's already going on. Taconite mining and block any new mining. And that used to be a solidly Democratic, the most solidly Democratic area of the state. Now it's bright red.
That's good. That would be great if they could take that Senate seat too. You know, that woman you describe her as a non-entity, Tina Smith.
She's a total zero. I'm not sure I could pick her out of a lineup.
That's what I was going to say. I don't. Most of these senators, I can recognize them because I've seen them on TV or in the on the internet. But I have no idea what she looks like.
A totally lazy campaigner. And the thing I wrote about on Powerline, Howie, of course, is some poll data came out just, what was it, last night or the night before, that the same outfit, Harper Polling Company, had polled in May and again just a few days ago. In May, Jason Lewis, the Republican, is running against Senator Tina Smith.
Talk show host, right? Former talk show host?
Yeah, former talk show host here and in North Carolina. Great guy, good friend of mine, principled conservative and a good candidate. And he's working greater Minnesota, outstate Minnesota, really hard, which is a smart strategy. You know, run up the score in those red areas of the state. Well, according to this Harper poll, in May they had him down by 11 points. This week they have him down by only 2 points. And so that's the result of hard campaigning. It's also the result of riots, looting, and arson, which I think the Democrats are really paying a price for.
Yeah, you know, you've been pretty blunt about what you think of Joe Biden's mental capacity. And I just want to play a couple of cuts for you from this afternoon in Kenosha, Wisconsin. Let's play the cut where he's talking about Bull Connor, Taylor. Listen to this.
But when Bull Connor, I was in grade school, when Bull Connor took those fire hoses and dogs on those black women going to church in their Sunday best and little kids having the skin ripped off them by these high-powered fire hoses.
That was 1965, John. He was 21, 22 years old. He said he was in grade school.
Yeah, did he mention that Bull Connor was a member of the Democratic National Committee? A true fact that not many people know.
Listen to this, too. Let me play one more. Cut 63. He's talking to a black audience here. Listen to what he says to a black audience, 63.
Because right now we're in a situation where you get out of prison, and I think you all know this, you get a bus ticket and $25.
I mean, what if Donald Trump said something like that, John? You know.
I mean, you know what I think, Howie? I'm getting more optimistic about this election all the time. And one of the reasons why I think the polls are tightening, and I think eventually Trump will be ahead in the polls and will win the election, you know, people are learning that Joe Biden is suffering from dementia. I mean, this is not a close case. This man is not fit to be president of the United States. And most people who follow politics only casually, which is, you know, 75% of the population, Joe Biden is just kind of a familiar name. Oh, yeah, I've heard of that guy. You know, that's about as deep as it goes. But as more and more people see him in action and hear him talk, the guy is obviously not mentally fit or physically fit to be president. And I think more and more people are having that realization.
Yeah, and one of your colleagues said that, you know, he didn't think Trump could be reelected if there 1,000 people a day continue to be dying from COVID-19. But, you know, the fact is, John, as you pointed out repeatedly, we don't know how many people are really dying. And now it turns out that even Nancy Pelosi, you know, is not taking this thing seriously. You know, I mean, she's criticized the president for not wearing a mask, and then she doesn't wear a mask herself. And she blames
in my opinion, is really the least of it. I mean, you're right about that. But the stunning hypocrisy, I mean, Gavin Newsom closes down all these small businesses. They're going broke. A lot of them are never going to reopen. Every hair salon in California is shut down by order of the governor. But Nancy Pelosi calls up and makes an appointment. So she's got the hair salon all to herself. It's closed. No other customers. The owner's going broke. But there's an independent contractor who's got a chair. And that's how Nancy gets in there. And so the owner of the salon is upset because, hey, look, you know, I'm going out of business. I can't feed my kids. And here's Nancy Pelosi just calling, making an appointment to illegally, that's the real point, Howie, illegally have her hair done. And so, you know, she puts out the video from the surveillance camera or whatever inside her salon, and there's Nancy Pelosi. And by the way, not wearing a mask, of course. It's kind of like Dr. Fauci throws out the first ball at a major league, you know, opening game, and the poor guy can't throw the ball more than about 20 feet. Did you see that? He was
worse
than Barack Obama. But of course, he's got a mask on. Okay, he's on the pitcher's mound. There's nobody within, you know, 30 yards of him,
right.
But he's wearing a mask on the pitcher's mound. But then you see him later on in the stands. The stands are empty, right?
Because
they don't have fans. Three people, him, I think his wife, and some other guy, and they're sitting there in adjacent seats, not social distancing, right next to each other, and he's not wearing a mask, chatting away with this buddy of his. So again, you know, the hypocrisy, but it also shows you what they really think. You know, they tell us how necessary these masks are.
It's like the guy from the UK who came up with the predictions that 2 million people were going to die in the U.S., and it's going to be the deadliest thing since, what the last time that he predicted 2 million people were going to die and 138 died. And then he's bringing in his girlfriend to, you know, I mean, it's just,
the UK,
it's just ridiculous. But we're supposed to take it seriously. And a huge percentage of the American people think 30 million Americans are dead. They don't know anybody who died, but they think 30 million people died.
Right. 9% of the population, that was the median answer in a poll that somebody did, and it's the death of common sense. I mean, if 9% of all the people in this country had died of COVID-19, that would be, you know, your neighbors, your family members, your coworkers. I mean, people would be dropping like flies. And apparently a lot of people have just stopped checking these kinds of wild claims against their own common sense.
Yeah, it's amazing. Powerlineblog.com, it's one of the best sites going. I check it out every day. You guys are the best, John Heindaraka. Thanks for being with us. We appreciate it. Never in the history of real estate have government-issued moratoriums against property owners been so widespread. They're putting moratoriums on paying rent. They're paying moratoriums on evictions. You can't evict somebody even if they just stop paying just to take advantage of the situation. Don't wait for the value of your property to sink any lower, especially if you own commercial real estate. For over 40 years, JJ Manning has been the leading auction house in New England. From rural farms, country clubs, estates, and historic office buildings throughout New England, J.J. Manning can get your property sold fast and with no contingencies. There's a big reason why Banker and Tradesman have voted J.J. Manning number one for the last 5 years in a row. They have the buyers and they pay cash. When you sell with a real estate broker, you have to pay commission as a seller. But with an auction, it's the buyer who pays. To learn more on how to get your property sold fast, contact Justin at jjmanning.com. That's Justin at jjmanning.com. With over 16,000 sales and satisfied clients, you can be the next one. Call them today at 800-521-0111 or go to jjmanning.com and get your property sold. Don't get caught flat-footed. Do it now. I'm Howie Carr.
Howie Carr. You can trust him. He's not like the others.
This is going to sound immodest, but I'm obviously a top-tier candidate. I've had a lot of titles over my career, and certainly vice president will be great, but Mamala will always be the one that means the most. They said, well, do you think Trump is responsible for what happened? And I said, well, look, I mean, obviously he didn't pull the trigger, but he's certainly been tweeting out the ammunition. And that's why do gotta go. What else do we know about this population, 18 through 24? They are stupid. That is why we put them in dormitories.
You know, I'm just gonna engage in real talk. I don't wanna waste your time with anything else.
What is your favorite musical genre?
Oh, I mean, I'm hip-hop and reggae and jazz. Those are some of my favorites.
Okay.
Have you ever smoked?
I have.
Okay.
Back in and college, I inhale. I did inhale.
We all shop online, and now you could do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal. When you check out, just click the Apply Coupons button that pops up. Wait a few seconds for Honey to scan its database of all the working coupons on the web. Then watch your price drop. Honey works on nearly every online store, including Walmart, Target, Home Depot, Macy's, Etsy, and more. And Honey has found over $2 billion in savings for its users. That's why it has over 100,000 five-star reviews on the Google Chrome Store. It's 100% free to use and installs in seconds. Plus, it's backed by PayPal, so you know it's secure and reliable. Not using Honey is literally passing up free money. So get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/Howie. That's joinhoney.com/Howie.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020, but the main one is Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump, knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president.
I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, I never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be? Would I be I'd be the world's worst?
Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. I said, what are we? Okay, are we allowed to grow too? Okay. No, are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide that bald spot, folks. I work harder. Doesn't look bad. Hey, we're hanging in.
I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year. Because I've destroyed her political career, and now I won't get a chance to run against her, and I would have loved it. I don't want to knock out all of the good stuff and end up with somebody that's actually got talent. That would be terrible.
This is Karen from Billerica, Massachusetts.
This is Adrian in Swanton, Vermont.
This is Miss Susan up in Warner, New Hampshire. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
844-500-4242. 619 says, Howie, what's so new about the Dems playing fast and loose with the votes? You as an expert on the Kennedys, didn't Momo Giancana, the head of the outfit in Chicago, stuff the ballot boxes in Chicago to give JFK Illinois and hence the presidency? Yeah, and LBJ stuffed them in Texas. So they cheat from at least 1960 on. What's new this time around? This time around, they're bragging about it before they do it. They weren't, you know, Momo wasn't going out and holding press conferences and going on TV and talking about what they were going to do. Neither was Mayor Daley, and certainly LBJ wasn't. 844-500-4242. Ted, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Ted.
Hey, Howie. Do you really doubt that Joe Biden was still in grammar school when he was 21?
You know, this is what God made fact checkers for, right? This is what we need, that nitwit from CNN and Glenn Kessler from the Washington Post. They got to get to the bottom of this. Was Joe Biden really in grade school at the age of 21 or 22 in 1965? That's a good point, though, Ted.
Hey.
Thanks for the call. 844-500-4242. You know how nasty these people are? We had the owner of Jamaica Jeff's on. He was the Belmont restaurant owner. It's a nice little place. He just opened it up last fall. It was doing great. Now it was shut down. And so when Charlie Parker was at a bicycle shop in Belmont last week, Jeff Lassiter is his name, went to the bicycle shop and said, "Hey, Governor, can you tell us what's going on with the restaurants? You're killing us. We can't get a call back from your office, the state rep's office, et cetera, et cetera." And Baker got all angry at him, and it was on TV, and we played it, and it was tweeted out. And so this is from the police blotter today in the Belmont newspaper. 9:32 a.m., August 26th. This is the day after he was on TV. Owner of Jamaica Jeff's reported threats he received on his work and personal Facebook pages. The Karens are on the march. On August 25th, the previous day, he spoke to Governor Charlie Baker at an event in Belmont. Local news stations filmed him speaking to the governor. After the event, he began to receive multiple messages on his Facebook page. One message said, quote, "You will be lucky if we do not protest in front of your business and home." So these people are going to protest that he wants to open things up. They're going to defy social distancing, et cetera, with the rules, and go and protest in front of his restaurant. He is concerned about the safety of his employees and family members. He does not feel threatened, but wants the incident documented. That was wise, I think. But this is what they're up against. These people got nothing better to do than sit at home and just take notes. And, you know, and then go out and try to hassle somebody who's already hanging on by the skin of his teeth. You know, he's just trying to keep his business going. And now with colder weather coming, and he's not going to be able to do any of the outside seating in the street after September 27th. What the hell is he going to do? And they're after him. I'm Howie Carr.
You know what? We got us a couple of real Karens here at Matthews Brothers, and a Kendra. We also have 8 Bills, 7 Johns, 4 Jims, Richards, and Mikes. What about Bob, you ask? Well, we got 3 of them, and 3 Amandas, Garys, Jordans, Kevins, Steves, and Waynes. We've got 2 each of Andys, Angelas, Anthonys, Ashleys, Bryans, Casey's, Charlies, Christopher's, Dan's, David's, Debbie's, Eric's, Jeff's, Jessica's, Joseph's, Joshua's, Logan's, Mason's, Nathan's, Patrick's, Paul's, Randy's, Rick's, Ryan's, Scott's, Tim's, Tom's, Travis's, and Matthew's, neither of them with one T, and 102 other uniquely named individuals. These are the 10 score and 19 people that every day put on their boots, sneakers, or other closed-toed footwear, come in and do their job, whether they work the first shift or second, in scheduling or logistics, the cut line, the screen line, the paint line, or the glass line, customer service, wrapping, added value, or one of the many production lines. They're all part of our legendary Main Made awesomeness. You can learn more about our wicked awesome Main Made windows and doors, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals, or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. That's Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
Remember the boy who cried wolf? I call this one the press that cried Hitler.
The president is not only racist, he's a bigot, but he is completely un-American. He is behaving like a fascist.
This is the president once again just thumping his chest and acting like he is the dictator that I think he wants to be.
The president of the United States is a wannabe dictator with authoritarian tendencies.
This is exactly what authoritarians do. This is what strong men do. This is what happens in authoritarian regimes.
We have a president with a strong authoritarian personality.
Like a dictator
leader from another nation.
People that grew up in authoritarian regimes, seeing echoes of that in President Trump, he likes these figures like Vladimir Putin and Kim Jong-un.
This is more the actions of a dictator.
He totally wants to be a dictator. It's so obvious.
Much like Hitler took over the Nazi Party, Trump has taken over the Republican Party.
He went full Hitler.
Trump is as destructive a person in this century as Hitler, Stalin, and Mao were in the last century.
It's simply a Stalinist phrase, for God's sake.
He sounded not like a president of the United States. He actually sounded like Saddam Hussein.
Whether it's global warming, global cooling, or climate change, one thing's for certain, the progressive moonbats can't stop talking about it.
We're talking about cities all over the world, major cities going underwater.
You know, I've spent a lot of time now with these young students, and they're scared. And a lot of young people are even suffering from, they're calling it extinction illness.
So that we can have people here who truly are committed to climate change, believe in climate change as though it's a religion, it's not a science.
A woman whose dreams of motherhood now taste bittersweet because of what I know about our children's future.
You have stolen my dreams and my childhood with your empty words.
That curing cancer is going to be much more difficult when there's so much climate change and pollutants in the environment, because a lot of cancer is environmentally caused.
Recognizing and acknowledging the link between animal agriculture and climate change is a very bold move, making tonight plant-based.
Listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
Here's 1 minute with Governor
Charlie Parker in Massachusetts.
I'd certainly put myself on that list. I'm a basketball player. I always was.
There's a lot at stake here.
This is not a virus to be trifled with or disrespected.
Respect the virus.
I have a hard time understanding when we're going to be able to play basketball again.
We can start talking about a gradual, careful, data-driven, phased reopening. Don't let a few nice days step on that.
I need to talk to the Attorney General and find out what the actual parameters of the ruling are. Did this just happen? And the reason I read that story is because I'm a basketball player, and I agree.
I was first made aware of the discrepancy on this on the day that the registrar resigned.
The vast majority, and I mean like the vast majority of the people who were part of these protests, are there to make a point and to make it peacefully. That is so obvious, I'm amazed that anybody could say anything other than that. I would love to be able to open everything up tomorrow. That would be an incredibly irresponsible thing to do.
And now, a minute of wisdom from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Millennials and people and, you know, Gen Z and all these folks that come after us are looking up and we're like, the world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is... Your biggest issue is how are we going to pay for it? Mm-hmm. And like, this is the war. This is our World War II.
I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important.
And if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all three chambers of Congress, all three chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy now.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much, but no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gunnar since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gunnar is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time up at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that. With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show, and for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a 2-year contract. You just order online. Set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more, all for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com.
Normally, we give Fredo Cuomo a lot of attention, but lately, it's Governor Andrew Cuomo who's been grabbing headlines. Let's take a listen to some of his best moments.
You're an essential worker, so go take a job as an essential worker.
But the people aren't hiring because of the
No, there are people hiring. You can get a job as an essential worker. So now you can go to work and you can be an essential worker and you're not going to kill anyone.
The number is down because we brought the number down. God did not do that. Fate did not do that. Destiny did not do that.
We're not going to make America great again. It was never that great.
Because I can all see you are in masterful shape, buff even.
It has a very nice floor.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
A questionable decision and new video causing grief for House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. The video shows her inside a hair salon this week in San Francisco. That is apparently against the rules. No indoor visits allowed. She's also seen not wearing a mask.
Maybe she was listening to the president who said masks are weakness. Who's always encouraging people to take off masks.
You need help. You need professional help.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
I take responsibility for trusting the word of a neighborhood salon that I've been to over the years many times.
You know she is a witch. She looks like one.
As it turns out, it was a setup.
I'm just a patsy.
So I take responsibility for falling for a setup. And that's all I'm going to say on that.
And that's all I had to say about that.
Instead of claiming a setup, it would have been just as easy for the speaker to say, you know what, I messed up.
It's kind of strange coming from you.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
President Trump has actively been trying to kill New York City ever since he's been elected. He can't come back to New York. He can't. He's going to walk down the street in New York. Forget bodyguards. He better have an army if he thinks he's going to walk down the street in New York.
You know something, Princess? You are ugly when you're angry.
Unchained and unstoppable.
Mail-in voting is fraught with the risk of fraud and coercion.
But since then,
Let me talk.
Yeah, please.
The only time the narrative changed is after this administration came in. And people trying to change the rules to this methodology is reckless and dangerous. And the people are playing with fire.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
844-500 4242, that is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. We talked with James O'Keefe from Project Veritas earlier in the day, in the first hour of the show, about another bust that he made. Basically, he caught a guy from West Lebanon, West Lebanon, voting twice in 2016 election, and the state attorney general knew about it apparently, but didn't do anything about it. So after we ran the story, the union leader put up a story. I assume they knew about it, but they probably weren't planning to put it up until tomorrow. A West Lebanon man was charged with voting twice in the 2016 election and has used his alter ego being a female, by the way, named Helen Ashley. His name is Vincent Marzello, to sign up as a 2020 campaign ballot inspector for the New Hampshire Democrat Party. Try not to let this destroy your faith in the integrity of the New Hampshire Democrat Party, that they're using a man who is dressing as a woman to be one of their ballot inspectors. State police arrested Vincent Marzello, 65, today and charged him with voting twice in Lebanon, first as himself, Vincent Marzello, and the second time as Helen Elizabeth. That's Elizabeth with an S, not a Z. Ashley. Both votes were cast from someone claiming to live at 101 Maple Street in West Lebanon. State prosecutors say Marzello then used Ashley's name to be assigned as an inspector for the upcoming elections. Deputy Attorney General Jane Young confirmed that the Attorney General Gordon McDonald decided late Wednesday to arrest Marzello after James O'Keefe, founder of the conservative Project Veritas campaign, met with Young and other AG staffers in person about the matter earlier in the same day. State prosecutors first received information about Marzello at the end of 2019. The case did not get followed up in a timely manner, in part because the AG redeployed staff. Oh, okay. They redeployed staff from its election laws unit to other tasks to deal with the COVID-19 pandemic and the economic downturn. Without the involvement of the Project Veritas, would we have brought the case today? Likely not. We have a couple more voter cases in the run-up to the presidential election. We're giving them to more than just the one attorney we have in the election law unit. Okay. 844-500-4242. But Young, the assistant AG, flatly denied the notion that her office had earlier decided not to arrest Marzello, also known as Helen Elizabeth Ashley, for this offense. That chatter is absolutely false, she said. Okay. All right. Mary.
Very fake news.
Mary, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Mary.
Hi, Howie. Just a couple of things quickly. I'm looking at the Thursday edition of the New Hampshire Union Leader.
Right.
We have attorney generals, county attorney generals in the state that are unbelievable. Mr. Conlon, who is the attorney general for Hillsborough County, his resume to run was he was an attorney. He had such mismanagement in his office that in 2019, the Hillsborough County Chiefs of Police Association, in an unprecedented move, issued a vote of no confidence in Mr.
Yeah.
Conlon.
Yeah, I don't know about any of that. This is a job for the Attorney General. I don't know what the DA does in Hillsborough, which is I guess Manchester. But thanks for the call. 844-500-4242. By the way, it is the end of a dynasty. The Kennedys have been defeated. There will not be a Kennedy in Congress unless Patches Kennedy's wife can prevail in South Jersey against Jeff Van Drew, the Democrat-turned-Republican congressman. So this will be the first time since 1947 that there hasn't been a Kennedy in office in D.C. 1947. Really, that's pretty amazing. But anyway, if you want to celebrate or commemorate the end of the Kennedy dynasty, I have a couple of books here. Kennedy Babylon, Volume 1, A Century of Scandal and Depravity, and Kennedy Babylon, Volume 2. And this is a $39.98 value, and you can get them right now for $14.95. They're both autographed. I autographed a bunch of them. And just go to HowieCarrShow.com, HowieCarrShow.com, and click on the store, and you can get the Kennedy Babylon special for $14.95, both of them autographed. And it's almost 600 pages of scandal and tawdry rotten, backstabbing, corkscrewing, double dealing behavior. And it's good reading. Good reading. And there'd be a lot of pictures right from the Herald photographic department that you've never, photos you've never seen before. And we actually bought some photos, FBI files you've never seen before, I dare say. You'll enjoy these books. Kennedy Babylon, A Century of Scandal and Depravity, Volumes 1 and 2, 600 pages of reading and watching for $14.95. It's a hell of a deal. 844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. When we come back, we're going to have the sound cuts from this afternoon, the press conference that Tal Duvall, Charlie Parker, had. And he's had a lot of really bad press conferences lately, but, and I don't want to overstate the case, but this could be the worst one yet. This, he is so obnoxious. And again, we're getting the same calls. We talk about this guy, Vincent Marzullo. Vincent Marzullo is no relation to James Marzilli, the former state senator from Arlington, who was also known as the perv in the Prius. And I don't know where he is, but he is not living in, he doesn't even look like Vincent Marzullo. And by the way, Vincent Marzullo in the video, I don't know if they posted it yet at Project Veritas, but he does have a ponytail. He's bald and he has a ponytail. But that's not the, but in the challenged voter affidavit, which we tweeted out earlier, he's wearing a really bad wig, a really bad wig for a woman. At least he looks like he shaved, though, before he went in to try to vote as Helen Elizabeth Ashley, which is, I'm sure that's more than most of them are gonna do it. 508 says, Helen Elizabeth Ashley was set up. Yes, she was. Thanks for pointing that out. All right. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
He didn't come here to be made sport of. Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Precinct 10 Restaurant in Weymouth. From their creamy baked mac and cheese with short ribs to their Louisiana-style paella, Precinct 10 is first class. Open at 4, Tuesday through Sunday for dine-in and curbside takeout.
Hey guys, you all know we sold out of the Fresh Rest bedding sheets during the Cheap Aster deal, but I have great news. Fresh Rest bedding is selling all sheets at 40% off now through September while supplies last. Go to freshrestbedding.com. For all orders over $50, you can also get free shipping. Fresh Rest bedding controls dust mites and pet dander. This special weave controls odors and you don't need to wash them every week. Order yours today at freshrestbedding.com and enjoy a good night's sleep.
Alexander Hamilton said, "Those who stand for nothing will fall for anything." This is Toby from Cape Gunworks. When our founding fathers drafted the Second Amendment, there was no question of its meaning. Today, if you have questions, come to Cape Gunworks for some advice, training, or to send a few rounds downrange. We have a fully stocked pro shop with a huge selection of guns, crossbows, archery, classes, rentals, a 15-lane range, and a friendly staff. Come on down to Cape Gunworks, Airport Road, Hyannis, or capegunworks.com.
Are you aware that the Episcopal Archbishop of Washington and the presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church nationally all denounced this police assault on the civil rights and civil liberties of the people?
Did they do that before or after the fire was put out?
Do you want to rephrase what you're doing? Because I think the word spying could cause everybody in the cable news ecosystem to freak out.
I'm not sure of all the connotations of that word that you're referring to, but, you know, unauthorized surveillance.
Okay, thank you.
Is that more appropriate in your mind?
This is your call. I really did want to give you a chance to say it how you wanted to say it and make sure that you didn't misspeak.
How can you sit here and tell us why should I investigate the President of the United States if you're not even aware of the facts concerning the president using the pardon or commutation power to swap the silence of a witness?
Because we require, you know, a reliable predicate before we open a criminal investigation.
Do you think that this body right here would rise up if they decided to go tonight and paint the Capitol building?
This body, I'm not sure.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day. Once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body. Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
The coronavirus has made our lives unpredictable, but one thing you can always count on, the White House press corps will always ask President Trump ridiculous questions.
Question, Mr. President, should Americans have to decide between staying healthy and going back to work?
Hey, I was just checking on oil again today. I was wondering
if... Oil?
Yeah.
Where is it today?
Well, I was wondering if you...
No, where's the price? Give me the price.
I'm not sure, to be honest.
How can you ask a question when you don't know the price?
I'll look it up for you.
Okay, let me do something else.
What do you say the Americans were scared, though? I guess nearly 200 dead, 14,000 who were sick, millions, as you witness, who are scared right now. What do you say to Americans who are watching you right now who are scared?
Well, where did he come from, the Inspector General? What's his name?
It came from the Inspector General.
No, what's his name?
I don't know his name.
Some of your allies have been bashing these doctors. Would you tell them to cut it out?
Today you tweeted, the invisible enemy will soon be in full retreat. Given it's invisible, without widespread testing, how would you know?
Hi, this is John in the People's Republic of Amherst, Massachusetts.
This is Heather from Litchfield, Maine.
This is Kent, Wichita, Kansas, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Where was that?
Today's poll question is brought to you by Genesis 950, sending warm thoughts to all the cars after Mr. Gooner's passing. Before you replace your carpets due to pet stains, try Genesis 950. It breaks down the bonds of stains and odors from the carpet and padding. Order direct at genesis950.com. Put in code word Howie and get free shipping and a free spray bottle with a 1 gallon purchase of Genesis 950. That's a $10 savings. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Was Nancy Pelosi set up?
No. Just like Helen Ashley was set up. No.
95% say no.
All right. 844-500-4242-603 says Helen Ashley looks a lot like Annie Custer. She's this congresswoman. You think so? The top, a couple of the VIPs think it. Yikes.
Looks more like Michelle Koslick.
Michelle Koslick being formerly, I think, James Koslick. It was the guy who killed his wife and then wanted us. Michael Koslick?
It really does have a very Silence of the Lambs vibe to it, though. The wig and the fur
coat. Good morning, Clarice.
Yes. Exactly.
I hope this gets the national attention it deserves, but I doubt it. Because as Bill Barr said, it's a little different media now than it used to be.
Yes. Well, it was amazing. Bill Barr said, Wolf Blitzer is asking him, do you enjoy being attorney general? And then he said, well, I wouldn't say I enjoy it. It's satisfying. And he said, well, last time you were with a different president, basically trying to get him to say this president you're with now is not as good.
Is a jerk.
And Bill Barr said, well, the media used to be fair. And Wolf Blitzer had the gall to say, well, at CNN, we're very fair. I'm sure you can appreciate that. And Bill Barr is so damn funny. He just goes, okay. He really is awesome.
All right. So, Grace, the governor was having his pre-Labor Day press conference. Being the true hack that he is, when he left, he said, have a nice weekend. Oh, really? It's Thursday. I guess he's a Republican. If he'd been a Democrat, he would have said it yesterday.
At 2 o'clock.
Right, exactly.
Howie, I'm starting to feel like when people see me on here now at 6 o'clock, I'm like the cat who sits on someone's bed before they die. Like they know that I'm coming with bad news of Charlie Baker.
But he doesn't do it as often as he used to.
I'm like the cat who sits on someone's bed before they die.
What happened there? Uh-oh, it was a repeat.
That was my...
Stuck in the loop.
Yeah, ooh. All right, guys, so I guess we do have to get through it, though. Let's start with Charlie Baker. So he gave a press conference today, and now he's handing me the highlighter. Okay, we're going to go through all of them.
Because I don't want to repeat myself, because we got enough. I don't need to take a call for the rest of the show. There's so many of them.
And I know.
And they're really horrible, but we'll take some calls, though, after this.
He had a little bit of Joe Biden in him today. He was stumbling a little bit in the beginning. Let's play cut 19.
And we continue to urge residents to get tested. If you feel sick or you were in close contact with someone.
But, I feel kind of sick today.
And then he struggled again. This is cut 20.
Many of these tests can be done through our Stop the Spread program, where free testing is deployed strategically to high prevalence communities.
But the biggest mess up as far as stumbling happened when he was discussing how the state police are breaking up gatherings. This is cut 29.
The Executive Office of Public Safety and Security and the Mass State Police are also working closely with the ABCC and local law enforcement in these communities to monitor and issue fines to businesses and break up large gatherings that aren't in compliance with state guidelines.
He was in a hurry to get to the weekend.
Yeah.
Yeah. Unorganized gatherings.
He has a very an obsession lately with unorganized, unsupervised gatherings. And that came
and
up.
And joy, too.
Yes, we will
He's
get...
opposed to joy. He actually came out today and said that he is opposed joy. To joy.
It's a tough stance to take, but he's taking it.
Does that mean he's also against the sun?
No, he likes the sun. Okay, let's do, I want to do unsupervised events. This is cut 23.
Time and time again, as our contact tracers have reached out to and engaged people who've become infected, gatherings, unsupervised, unofficial, people being familiar with people they're familiar with, play a major role in the spread of COVID generally in communities around the Commonwealth.
So I find that he likes that phrase, people being familiar with people they're familiar with.
Play a major role. Being familiar with people they're familiar with.
I don't find it particularly clever or insightful, that phrase, but he says it all the time. People being familiar with people they're familiar with. I wouldn't be surprised if he has
given,
a tattoo
given
on
his,
it.
Given his actions, though, Grace, do you really think he's spending a lot of time with high Mensa IQ types? I mean, he's doing everything wrong. He's doing everything stupid. He's got his number one in unemployment and number three in deaths. I mean, it's not like he's Winston Churchill during the Blitz.
You know what I just realized? I have all of these cuts, but there's cuts that I still need that I'm going to have to get during the break because a reporter started asking him. So yesterday, Charlie Baker said, oh, I was on the blue line a lot and no one in the media noticed it. And I was really, as someone who is, you know, D-list over here, I was like, that sounds like a D-list celebrity trying to get paparazzi to take their photo. Like, why didn't any of you guys pick this up? So a reporter today at the press conference started asking him about that and was basically saying, like, why would you be on the blue line? And like, who,
yeah, right. I mean, it doesn't run to Swampscott. That's all you got to ask yourself. Why would you be on the blue line?
And he kept asking him questions. And Charlie Baker was like, well,
did you hitchhike home from Orient Heights?
And he said,
did you walk through Lynn to get to Swampscott?
So believe it or not, we'll have more cuts when we come back. but we'll keep going through these. So Charlie Baker is extremely proud of his new digital campaign to stop the spread. This is cut 26.
Oh, boy.
It includes, among other things, a new website platform, mass.gov/stopcovid19, advertising on billboards and digital and social media, downloadable materials available in multiple languages, multilingual field teams deployed in these communities, phone and text communications, and outreach to local community groups.
I want to get to mass.gov/stopcharlieparker.
Howie, he's been working on this website for a long time. He was very, very.
I think
proud
he'd get a lot
website.
More clicks, hits if he had a mass.gov stop Charlie Parker.
But the cool thing is, so all these businesses that are really, you know, their necks are being stepped on by Charlie Baker. There is an upside. There is downloadable stuff on these websites that businesses can print out and put in their windows. I'm not saying that's going to make everything better, but it's got to help a little bit.
What does it have? A sign that says closed?
Yeah.
Will not be reopening.
This is
Charlie Parker killed us.
Cut 20.
The new website at mass.gov/stopcovid19 will allow residents and business owners in these communities to get more information and download materials that can be displayed in their businesses, apartment complexes, restaurants, and other community organizations.
Ugh. Keep going.
No, when we get back, though, that's when we're going to get... If you think this is bad, it gets a lot worse. He starts talking about how he hasn't been able to hang out with his friends again.
What friends? Comes the recurring question. What friends? I'm Howie Carr.
Hey, Howie, I see you got a haircut again.
Yes, I did, Grace. It looks good, doesn't it?
It definitely looks better than that haircut you got a few years ago before you met the president. Remember that bad buzz cut, Howie?
Geez, you love bringing that up, don't you?
Well, I just think that your bad haircut was a true testament to the wonderful work of Dr. Hines at DiStefano Hair Restoration. Because even though you looked crazy at the time, your hair grew back, and now you look as dapper as ever.
That's true. Dr. Hines did such a wonderful job on my hair. I love waking up every day not worrying about bald spots or a dreaded comb over. I now have a thick head of hair, and the best part of it is, it's my hair. Getting a DiStefano hair restoration was the best decision I ever made.
Well, besides hiring me, right, Howie?
Like I said, Grace, it was the best decision I ever made.
You heard him, guys. Go to hairman.com to get the hair you've always wanted. Get hair like Howie's. Go to DiStefano Hair Restoration. They have 5 locations in New England, and they are open for business. That's hairman.com. And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure.
No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy, and I think you'd have more viewers or readers if people address concerns that people have. The list goes on about the
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon started about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's Everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie. And now, a minute of wisdom from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Millennials and people and, you know, Gen Z and all these folks that come after us are looking up, and we're like, the world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is your biggest issue is how are we going to pay for it? Mm-hmm. And like, this is the war. This is our World War II.
I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important.
And if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all three chambers of Congress, rather all three chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
Are we starting to feel bad for Joe Biden? Sorta. Are we going to play his gaffes anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States, next senator.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean, here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday. I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I? We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by, you know the thing. It says you cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Chris.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920 and not 2020.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
You're enjoying your day, everything's going your way. Then along comes Charlie Parker. Always there to tell you about a new disease, a car accident, or killer bees. We beg her to spare you,
Charlie, please.
But you can't stop Charlie Parker.
Did Charlie Parker mention people, familiar people getting familiar with people they aren't familiar with, like his son did on that airplane?
Please tell me they were wearing face coverings.
We can play another familiar one if you want. This is cut 38.
Most of the data, as we've said several times in this room, would indicate that each other being familiar with each other. That is by far the single biggest issue we face.
And another big problem in our society is people getting familiar with people they aren't familiar with, especially on airline flights after they've had a couple of drinks of wine.
Okay,
603 says, by the way, we don't need a multilingual app to understand the word unemployed. And here's another one. For another 603, these are good ones from New Hampshire or New Hampshire phones. Hey, Charlie, how about stopping the spread of unemployment?
But you know what's crazy is usually with local reporters, we say this a lot, they're better than the national reporters. They're not as caught up in trying to get, you know, famous from it. They do want to get information. But the disconnect between what regular people want to know and what the reporters are asking, one of the questions was something like, you mentioned it's multilingual, but I don't see this language on here. And I was just thinking to myself, what? Like, no, that's not.
I know. Again,
what
again,
people want to know right now.
That's why the text was right on target. You know, we don't need multilingual app to say unemployed.
Okay, so we have to start really getting through here because there's a lot. Let's talk about, we knew that COVID was not going to take the summer off. Charlie told us that. So this is cut 32.
As people have heard me say many times over the course of the past few months, COVID clearly doesn't and won't and didn't take the summer off. And for the most part, people around the Commonwealth did their jobs this summer by wearing face coverings, socially distancing, and keeping their gatherings small and manageable.
Except for the lieutenant governor.
Now, Taylor, I'm warning you that we will need at some point during these next couple ones a womp womp, because this is when he gets really, really sad. This is cut 33.
As we head into yet another holiday weekend and our back to school season, it's important that all of the Commonwealth's residents stick to these proven practices. COVID is highly contagious, and it's going to be with us until we have a treatment or a vaccine. Everyone needs to continue to take it seriously and not let down their guard.
That's perfect.
How about yet another holiday weekend? You know, holiday weekends don't mean as much when you don't have a job. You know, every day is kind of a holiday, only it's not a holiday if you don't have anywhere to go.
Right. It's like every day is Christmas.
And we're getting into the back to school season. Who's going back to school, Charlie? Who's going back to school?
I think this next cut, though, was his most classic Charlie Parker being a Debbie Downer moment. This is cut 34.
Everyone needs to continue to take it seriously and not let down their guard. You can do your part. You can help protect yourself, your loved ones, and your community from COVID by wearing a face covering, socially distancing, washing your hands, and recognizing and understanding that this virus will spread if you give it the opportunity to do so. So let's all have a nice Labor Day weekend and do the things we know work when it comes to managing and containing COVID.
Let's all have a nice Labor Day weekend, and let's celebrate the fact that we're number one in unemployment and only number three, but we're trying to do better in the death rate.
He also he brags at some point during this, which we will get to, about the employment numbers. But before that, he brags about the number of inspections that are now happening for people breaking the COVID. I'm assuming that's what the inspections are for, is people breaking the rules.
Yeah. So this is it. I'd like to speak to my main constituency, which is Karens. Yeah. Karens and hacks. And so, Karen, if you call in, one of my hacks will go down to the business and to make it even harder for them to continue in business. And if we have any luck at all, we'll just shut off their power and their electricity and write them out a citation.
But Howie, to your point before we play it, I was just saying about the reporters, the disconnect, they also continuously ask him, you know, this party wasn't shut down fast enough. There's a lot of complaints that you guys aren't, you know, interrupting these things and breaking them up. And I'm just thinking, who are they getting this from, that people are mad about people gathering? Like, it's got to be one person.
Does he care? This is just another thing. Universal Hub, local website. Another Boylston Street bar shuts down. Lear announced today it's shutting down less than a day after the neighboring Poorhouse, P-O-U-R, house announced its closure. And then this is McGreevy shut down like 2 weeks ago.
And the Four shut down this week.
Well, that's up on Canal Street. This is just, this is Boylston Street, three bars in 2 weeks. On Canal Street, it's like four bars, restaurants in 2 weeks.
We will get to the restaurant issue in a moment. But first, let's hear Charlie bragging about the inspections. This is cut 36.
Between the state police, the ABCC, the Department of Labor Standards, and the Division of Professional Licensure, there have probably been more than 1,000 inspections.
Yeah, we'll teach them.
Across these communities.
We'll show them.
Since this effort began.
Keep going with that.
35 was good. Well, now what we have to get to is the tired part. So I guess, and Howie, I'm blanking on who the mayor was, who he was with.
Arrigo from Revere.
I didn't watch the mayor's part of the speech, but Charlie was referencing that the mayor said people are tired of, you know, all of these things that are happening. And
he's an old hack from the T.
So
maybe he rode the blue line with Charlie. I don't know.
So Charlie was basically talking about how he understands that people are tired, and he's tired, and his staff is tired. This is cut 39.
Now, let me just follow up on that. The mayor made an excellent point when he talked about the fact that people are tired. I got news for you. I am too. So is the lieutenant governor. So Secretary Sutter's, and so are a lot of the people who work on our teams. And I know the mayor and his folks are also tired.
You know what, Charlie? A lot of people are tired of not getting a paycheck.
Yeah.
For the fact that all these people are dead who were in nursing homes that you were supposed to be regulating. 65% of the dead people, 5,800 Massachusetts residents are dead in nursing homes that were paying you money, $52,000.
But that's
you were looking the other way.
That's the thing, is that he references his staff and, you know, Lieutenant Polito being tired. They're getting paid. It eases the exhaustion when you're getting a paycheck. It makes it feel like it's worth it. Other people are tired and they're not.
Yeah, so and how tired are the nursing home inspectors that let 5,800 people die in the nursing homes? Are they tired, Charlie? Are you tired? Is your superintendent at the Holyoke Soldiers Home that gave you $950 and gave Karen Polito $1,000? Is he tired?
Now he talks about how he hasn't seen his friends in a while.
Not again. Is he missing basketball again too? Someone wants to know how the White Shadow is handling this.
This is cut 40.
None of us were brought up anticipating that we would end up living a significant portion of our lives away from a lot of the people that we normally spend time with.
None of us were brought up.
I said before that there's a group of about 10 people.
Hold on, Taylor, stop
that. Outside of work.
None of us were brought up to think that some idiot could shut down our businesses indefinitely in an attempt to defeat the sitting president of the United States. And then blame everybody else for his own total mismanagement of the state of Massachusetts, leading to most of the deaths. That's what I never imagined happening. And I've lived through the governorships of Mike Dukakis and Deval Patrick. I never could have imagined this kind of incompetence.
You don't know what these eyes have seen.
I know. I go back a long way.
These eyes have seen a lot of love. That's what Howie's saying. He's seen Mike Dukakis.
Yes. Keep playing. I'm sorry to interrupt.
When I said before that there's a group of about 10 people outside of work that represent the entire universe of the community that I've spent time with and my wife has spent time with since March.
So he says that all of this is psychologically exhausting. This is cut 41.
And the constant inability to hug people, to engage in any kind of sort of traditional group gathering that we would normally do as a matter of course on a regular basis is psychologically exhausting.
How about the group gathering of being able to go to work? How about the group gathering of being able to go to a restaurant for dinner? How about the group gathering of sitting down at a bar?
Howard, he does mention not being able to go to work. He has to do a lot of Zoom calls, Charlie Baker.
Yeah, that's true. How about not being able to play pinball? I used to like to play pinball back in the day.
Let's skip to...
That's right. I can still go to the one-armed bandit, though. Because the one-armed bandit doesn't spread COVID, but the pinball machine does. I got it. Where this is based on data. This is science, man.
Charlie Baker wants his staff to know that he misses them, and he also misses Yakety Yak. This is cut 45.
Yakety Yak. That was the name of my yearbook at UNC. That's what they called it. I thought it was lame then. All these years later, it's even lamer.
45.
I'm going to go back to where the mayor was with respect to people are tired. Look, I don't like the fact that so many of my friends aren't part of my life. But we don't do cabinet meetings anymore. We do Zoom calls. And on the Zoom call we did last week with the cabinet, I basically said, look, I miss you guys. I don't like the fact that I never have any
I
sort
miss
of
you, man.
Informal yakety yak.
Yakety yak. Don't
Take
come
out
back.
The papers and the trash. Why you don't get no spending cash? If you don't scrub that kitchen floor, you ain't gonna rock and roll no more.
Yakety yak. Don't come back.
Definitely don't talk back. End up in jail.
He can't see his friends. He can't hug his friends. As Macduff said of Macbeth, those he moves move only in command, nothing in love.
Oh, by the way, he's on to a new thing now, which is COVID's superpower. This is cut 46.
No, and I can't stress this enough, the COVID is all about the contagion. That's what it's all about. That's its superpower.
You thought Lex Luthor was tough? Brainiac? B.O. Plenty from the Dick Tracy comic strip? The Penguin? It ain't got nothing. None of them got nothing on COVID-19, man.
He's really into making COVID like this character, like you said.
It's like it's like the devil. I mean, if you'd listen to one of those old dollar holler preachers, you know, when I was in North Carolina, I'd listen to him on the radio driving around. Just substitute the word COVID or virus for Lucifer or Satan or whatever. It's the same thing.
Yeah. This is what it wants. This is what it wants. You have to respect it or else
you
it's going to take over. Very, very strange.
You'll be backsliding. We backsliding. You don't want to be backsliding, brothers and sisters. I can do that. when there was a crappy Tony Orlando and Don song on, I'd just click over and see what Reverend Shambaugh was pontificating on. The best way to listen to anything these days is with a pair of premium wireless earbuds, especially if you can get them at less than half the price of the other guys. That's why I recommend wireless earbuds from Raycon. Raycons are the best. I got some in the spring. I gave some to Grace for her birthday. Grace gave some to her father for Father's Day. And then what happened, Grace?
And then my dad started wearing them. My sister got jealous. My brother got jealous. So they all bought their own Raycons. We're a family of Raycon wearers. We wear them. We all listen to our own music. We bop around like the Brady Bunch.
And everybody in the neighborhood says they're really cool because they don't have any wires dangling.
Those curlies, man. They're cool. They're cool cats.
Raycon's newest model, the Everyday E25 earbuds, are their best ones yet with none of those wires, dangling wires, but they do have 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, a more compact design, a noise-isolating fit. Raycon earbuds are stylish and discreet, as I just said, no dangling wires or stems. The company was founded by Ray J and celebrities like Snoop Dogg, Brandy, J.R. Smith, and Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson! Is obsessed with their products. Give them a try. Raycon has a 45-day free return policy, so you can make sure they're the pair of wireless earbuds, not just for Mike Tyson, but for you. Now, for a limited time, get 15% off your order at buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie for a special 15% discount on Raycon wireless earbuds. Buyraycon.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
The Howie Carr Show.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Aviva Trattoria. From their famous chicken parm to their gluten-free menu, Aviva Trattoria has it all with locations in Marlboro, Westford, Wrentham, and Maynard. Stop in today or find them at AvivaTrattoria.com.
Are we starting to feel bad for Joe Biden? Sorta. Are we going to play his gaffes anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States, next senator.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean, here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday.
I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I?
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by, you know the thing.
It says you cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Chris.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920 and not 2020.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
Joe Biden might be running for president in 2020, so we should play some of his greatest hits.
Barack and I finally reduced the disparity in sentencing, which we've been fighting to eliminate, in crack cocaine versus powder cocaine.
Correct.
It was a big mistake when it was made. We thought, we were told by the experts that crack, you never go back.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
If you want to protect yourself, get a double-barrel shotgun. If there's ever a problem, just walk out on the balcony, put that double-barrel shotgun, and fire two blasts.
They're going to put you all back in chains. Give me a break. That's a bunch of malarkey.
The three-letter word, jobs. J-O-B-S, jobs.
One man stands ready to deliver change we desperately need. A man I'm proud to call my friend. A man who will be the next president of the United States, Barack America.
Hi, this is Cindy from Osterville, Massachusetts.
This is Brett Rock from Dunstable, Massachusetts.
This is Amy in Lisbon Falls, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
We were just talking about Kennedy stuff, and it is the end of the end of an era here this week with Joe Kennedy being defeated. So if you want to read up on great Kennedy scandal and depravity, this is a best deal you're ever going to get on books, 600 pages, Kennedy Babylon Volume 1 and Kennedy Babylon Volume 2, A Century of Scandal and Depravity. You can go to HowieCarrShow.com, click on store. You can get both of these books, Volumes 1 and 2, for $14.95. The usual price is $39.95, and they're autographed too. So go there at HowieCarrShow.com, click on store, and you'll hear lots of stories. Like the VIPs, you just heard a great story, right? Yeah. That's one of many, many stories. Please clap. One of many, many stories in Kennedy Babylon 1 and 2.
Okay, so we have a lot more Baker to get through. This was the big question of the press conference. A reporter asked him, let's just play the question because it was a good question. This is 48.
Governor, we've seen a handful of legacy restaurants in the last week close or they're changing hands because of COVID restrictions or the shutdown. Any consideration toward relaxing some of the restrictions with the infection rate?
So the question obviously is, you know, COVID really killed a lot of these restaurants. Howie listed a bunch of them before the break that are going out of business.
That was just today's list. My only dispute with that question is he said a handful. It's more than a handful.
Right.
And 603 says Charlie Parker line of Hallmark cards. Sorry you lost your job. Sorry your business failed. Sorry you couldn't evict your deadbeat tenants. Sorry you couldn't go back to school. Sorry you couldn't play high school football.
So his first crack at the question, we'll only play a little bit of this. He tries to blame that there's no sports for the reason the restaurants are going out of business. This is cut 49.
So it's sometimes hard to figure out what the root cause of some of these issues. I mean, it all comes back to COVID one way or another, right? But I've been thinking for a long time that the fact that the Bruins were playing in Toronto and the Celtics were playing in Florida and that their seasons for all intents and purposes were basically cut short.
Okay, let's cut it short there, Taylor, because I want to get to
the other two. Is that why the Fuddruckers in Methuen went out of business, Governor? Because they weren't getting a lot of walk-up traffic after the Bruins games? Or the Chateau in Westboro? Or Isaacs in Plymouth? Is that why they went out of business?
I want to skip to cut 51. He says it's not the rules' fault, it's the no customers. This is cut 51.
But if the customers aren't there, then the rules, on some level, really aren't at the end of the day, aren't going to solve the problem.
But this is the cut we really need to get to. This is Charlie Baker at a loss for words. It's like a four-part answer at this point.
What a dink this guy is.
Just saying, you know what? It stinks. This is what he has to say to the restaurant.
We continue to... it stinks.
Limerick guy says, Charlie Parker is making this out to be even scarier than the Blob movie from the 1950s. Where is Steve McQueen to rescue us, though? That's what I want to know. We'll see you tomorrow at Cape Gunworks in Hyannis. I'm Howie Carr.
If you're thinking of replacing your carpets due to pet stains and odors, you must try Genesis 950 first. It breaks down the bonds of stains and odors so they're gone from carpets and padding for good. You can use it in a carpet cleaning machine and it's green, so it's safe for family and pets. It was the go-to cleaner for when Mr. Gooner had an accident as older pugs so often do. Before you purchase new carpeting, you must try Genesis 950. 1 gallon of industrial strength Genesis 950 makes up to 7 gallons of cleaner, and it's not just for pet stains. It's a disinfectant that kills viruses as well. It's also great for kitchens, garages, grease stains, wheels, tires, and more. Save yourself the trouble of going to the store and seeing your favorite cleaner sold out again. You can just order it and have it delivered right to your doorstep. Genesis 950 is made in America. Order a gallon direct at genesis950.com. Enter code Howie to get more than a $10 value in savings, including free shipping and a free spray bottle with a 1 gallon purchase of Genesis 950. Go to genesis950.com and enter code Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy'd out.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much, but no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gunnar since